If you've not been to the Star down in Frisco, it's a pretty impressive deal. I was telling these young men, I said, you know that you're going into the most valuable sports franchise in the world. And maybe, can you make the argument, you know, with the Yankees, the most high profile in the world? I know you could say soccer.
I think those two have gone back and forth with most.
I wonder what's bigger internationally, the Yankees or the Cowboys? Yankees?
I think
baseball's not as popular as football.
Latin America have players in baseball more than football, I think. Would you say?
What about in Europe? You think they'd go football instead of baseball in Europe?
Well, our football is such a novelty to them.
Yeah,
I think
true.
It's cute.
Yeah,
because it's not.
Yeah,
because
not soccer.
Yeah. I think baseball is more, but that'll be my opinion.
I do want to say, if you look at your cameras, you can see Alicia Dover over here. Is the camera showing Alicia?
Not yet. I moved it to put it out here.
We're showing all the. There's Alicia.
There she is, right there.
Used to be with Channel 7, now has her own agency and for advertising, public relations with her husband, Jeremy. Got some interesting news with Jeremy coming up soon we'll be able to talk about. Can't say much now, but he's always working hard and busy. Of course, you know, tonight too, Roger, this is a crazy day because we've got here what we're doing here in Conway. Then I'm headed down to Dallas. You're headed to Oakland tonight for trivia.
Yeah.
I'll come back and we have a Hall of Fame reception. And then you got Skinnerd and ZZ, which, you know, I don't know if I'm going to be out of gas by the time I get to that thing tonight.
Yeah,
and then we're back in Little Rock.
Kaufman.
Design. Yeah. So it's going to be a crazy fun time. But
what are you more excited for, Baz? Skinnerd or ZZ? No, I'm serious.
That's a good question. I don't know. I think by tonight.
Are they playing together or they're playing
separate. Yeah. Skinnerd is the closer. So they're the bigger. And you only got half of ZZ Top. You got half of that.
Well,
you got two thirds.
That's right. You got two thirds.
Yes.
You got two thirds.
Is that right? You got two thirds. Is that what it is?
Yeah, because there's two.
No top.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. We'll talk with the folks here in Conway, the Conway Expo Center. It's the forever event put on by the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. It's called Build My Future. And you're going to have 1,200 students in doing hands-on things. Again, it's not a job fair. It's an opportunity to expose young people to maybe a future in doing something else. And as we talked about, not everybody's going to be radio superstars like you.
Yeah, because I can't even hang a floating check. I spent more money on repairing what I did on a floating.
Let me ask you this. I noticed they've got a jackhammer. Have you ever done a jackhammer before? Have you ever?
Maybe tried it, but. But no, that was a pogo stick.
They're going to have a burn demonstration.
I know Bill was telling me about that.
It's going
to be outside. They've got they're going to show you what sprinklers can do. So they've got a tray. They've got some furniture. They've got all that out there. About 11 o'clock, they're going to set one of them on fire.
Yes,
the flashpoint, put it out, and then they'll do the same thing with the sprinkler system.
How about roof and caulking joints on walls? I wish I could caulk better. Wish I had the skill to caulk.
I do too. There's nothing.
Like I always love seeing guys who can caulk.
If you can caulk,
boom.
You got that little tool where you
yes,
caulk.
That's it.
Listen, if I could caulk and get a weld bead, click click.
bead,
you kidding me?
Did you say bead?
Bead,
you B-E-A-D. You're talking about on a weld?
Welding.
Look at you.
Listen,
welders are making huge money. I'm
telling you, dollar.
Welders make big money.
So
man.
Is the electricians.
I know.
Here.
I know.
Napoles is here. I mean, if you're been in Arkansas for any length of time, maybe 100 years, you know that name.
Yes.
Right. So they're here. There you go. 75 years. Look at that. I was close.
How about that?
But listen, I love watching some of that stuff go, because when somebody comes over, just when somebody puts the mount for a TV on my wall.
I know.
I mean,
I know.
I've got a stud finders. I've got levelers. I've got what do you call the chalk tape? Is that what it's called? What is that?
You pop a line.
I don't
know why. You pop a line.
I don't know why.
Now,
and I have a
you used to pop a line.
You used to pop chalk line.
It was different.
Chalk line.
It was a different line.
Oh, that's terrible. You know what?
That
you're
was
just
mean.
You know what? No.
It's just his life story.
No. Listen, that's what a buddy does to keep you grounded. Thank you.
Oh my gosh, you know what we just did? You see what we just did? Uh-uh. What did you just do to me?
High five.
You know what today is? National High Five Day. I am not joking. Today is National High Five Day. That's one of the many days we'll get to when we come back.
I can't wait.
We'll visit with some folks here involved with this great event today.
Chalk line.
If you want to be a part of the show, 661-1037 is the number. We'll see if Josh continues to keep the music low while we go to break. So we've got to play the clip.
I've got a surprise for y'all coming back.
I cannot wait to hear Justin trying to talk through your 1,000 decibels of music going on. All right. It is 6:30 live from Conway. I've lost it.
You have lost it.
Now you can watch all your favorite Buzz shows streaming live on our YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter pages. 103.7 The Buzz, your multimedia fun and game station.
This is SportsCenter.
Night number two of the NBA postseason is in the books. The Philadelphia 76ers are the 7th seed in the Eastern Conference. They beat the Miami Heat 105-104. It was 23 points and 15 rebounds for Joel Embiid, 19 points for Tyrese Maxey, and 20 points for Nicholas Batum off the bench. Miami will host Chicago. The Bulls beat the Atlanta Hawks last night 131-116 to win the second play-in game. A great evening for Coby White, who had 42 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists, 22 points and 12 boards for Nikola Vucevic, and then 22 points, 9 assists, and 6 boards for DeMar DeRozan. The Bulls and the Heat will meet on Friday night. The winner of that game will play the number one seed Boston Celtics in round number one. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz Weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too, a high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special, dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, two sides, and our famous salad bar. Only $60. Good. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Get the inside scoop from the Hill when Homer's Ace Hardware presents Arkansas second baseman Peyton Stovall on 103.7 The Buzz. Every Tuesday, Peyton joins Roger, David, and Justin on Morning Mayhem. They'll talk college baseball and whatever else comes to mind. It's Peyton Stovall every Tuesday morning with Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz. Made possible by Homer's Ace Hardware. Need help? Ask Homer at any of locations, Searcy, Beebe, or Cabot.
The newest Forest River dealership is now open in Little Rock. Visit Arkansas's premier Forest River dealer, specializing in the sales and service of the Forest River lineup, along with a large selection of quality pre-owned RVs. We have an RV for every lifestyle and a payment for every budget. Plus, as part of the Camping World Dealer Network, you will have access to our national network of lenders, nationwide service network, and all of the Good Sam products and services. We can't wait to serve you at our newest location in Little Rock.
See dealer. Full details and disclaimers.
Your husband is pretty handy to have around. He makes the world's best mac and cheese. He's in the Tickle Monster Hall of Fame. And he can teach anyone how to throw strikes. But a busted pipe and a basement full of water?
Honey, I think we need a plumber.
Is a little out of his league. That's where a homeowner's policy from Shelter Insurance comes in handy. We'll help get your house back in order and your husband back to what he does best.
See Shelter agents Brian Kress or Caleb Green in North Little Rock. We're in Brinkley, see agent Hunter Cornelison.
Hi, I'm Hunter Bell from Bell Chevrolet, and I want to tell you the real reason it's better at Bell. Our people, our family, and our community that drives us to be the best. We're proud to offer our biggest inventory and lowest prices on every single vehicle, from the all-new Silverado to the all-electric Chevy Equinox. We're going to find you the perfect vehicle with a buying experience like nowhere else. Our commitment is to you every day. Shop Bell Chevrolet and BellChevrolet.com today. Heather, let's drive.
Do you recycle? Sure you do. Or you'd like to. Recycling is easy because you don't have to separate recyclable material. We'll do that for you. Just throw it in the cart. Loose. No bagging. To do recycling right, you need to know what should go in your cart and what shouldn't. To learn more, go to MyDoRight.com. At MyDoRight.com, we'll show you how to do recycling right. Do right, and do it the right way.
This is Quinn Grovey, and you're listening to Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
And they get to go to a softball game and one night, either Friday or Saturday, you know, in the course of them playing the tournament. So it's kind of neat for the girls. And usually the softball, the Razorbacks, the softball team. They're really good about coming out, having autographs, and doing all that after the game. So
I'm sorry, Justin.
Josh, is there any reason we have that the volume so high that we can't hear
Justin? Or Justin's having a talk
over. Justin never stopped.
Never stopped.
He never stopped.
That is so good.
6:34 here on Morning Mayhem.
Good job.
If you want to be a part of the show, our text line is 661-1037.
Correct.
And it's D3 Auto. Yeah, is the new sponsor for that. As I mentioned, and Roger, you can check. For some reason, I'm not connecting on the on the text line. As I mentioned earlier, we're at the Conway Expo Center. It's an event called Build My Future, and it's put on by the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. Really unique deal. Got some folks here that are going to talk about it. Bill Rochelle, president of the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. That's ABC. Right, Bill?
That's right.
That makes sense. And Sheila Burrows with Nabholz. How are you, Sheila? Good morning.
Good, thank you.
Pull that mic right close to your mouth there. Now, Nabholz Construction has been around 75 years. And so, you know, I love the fact you guys have 1,200 students coming here today. And it's not a job fair. It's what was it?
Career?
It's not a career fair. It's more designed to give students an immersive learning experience more than anything.
Yeah, like an expo.
So. Was this your idea? Whose idea was this?
So we got the idea from our chapter down in Louisiana. Uh-huh. And then Steve Turner with Multicraft Contractors started to Build My Future event up in Northwest Arkansas. And so we've spent the last 3 years kind of going up there and helping him to get to the point where now we can, you know, do one here in Central Arkansas.
So this is not open to the public. So the 1,200 students, how did they choose to want to come here today? How did that work, that process?
They did. So we emailed all the superintendents and principals. We've got some students coming from as far away as Batesville.
Okay,
that are
going to
be here. So we've got about 1,200 students we're expecting today.
And the thing is, you know, you said it's not a career fair, but it really could turn out to be that. I mean, if somebody gets inspired and you know, and there's business like Nabholz here and others that, who knows? There may be somebody you hire down the road.
We've done that in Springdale. Absolutely.
What's happening at the Nabholz area? What do you have going on down there?
So we're going to build tables today.
Okay.
So we try to think of a project where we can do in a team format. So we're going to build as a team. So we're going to have 4 to 6 kids on each project. They're going to build that table. I think our guys are back there learning right now how to put that table together. So
okay.
Nice.
We had to bring
nice.
In the professional cabinet maker to help us.
We were here
again, cabinets.
We Absolutely. Were here yesterday, right down the road at Luxury Pool and Spa. And they built this unbelievable table out of this unbelievable wood. And Roger and I look around going, you know, good Lord, we wouldn't even know where to start.
We wouldn't even know. Hey, where do you get laughing?
And so who are all the different kind of companies here in addition to Nabholz? Who all is represented here today? So
we've got Nabholz. We've got Kenco. We've got CMS Wireless, ABC Block and Brick, Rogers Group, KJAX, Lexicon.
Anybody that relates to building, commercial or residential, whatever. Right. I mean, it's a little bit of everything. Correct.
We have more commercial construction contractors than we do home builders. But they represent all different facets of the construction industry.
It's Kuntz Electric in Morrilton.
Kuntz Electric is in Morrilton. They'll be here this morning as well.
They, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I mean, they do. They sponsor and are big with Sacred Heart up in that area. Because I remember when I do the trivia up there, and I think if that's Alicia Kuntz.
Alicia Kuntz,
maybe. I mean, she's a
You always talk about her.
Absolutely, you've met her before when we were at Elias and all. Well, I know that name, so it's almost okay. Very good.
And then we've got stuff outside. ABC Block and Brick's going to be here. North Little Rock Electric, Conway Corp, VSC Fire and Security. So we've got about 40 vendors that'll be on site.
Baz and I will go down the rabbit hole of these IG and maybe even the TikTok videos and all that. Some of my favorite are the construction. Talking about ABC Brick is to get that brick, put down the concrete with your little spatula, you put the brick down on that rascal, smooth out, you know, the concrete, use it again and splatter it on for the next brick and bring up more. It's such a methodical thing. And I could watch that. To me, that's like watching Bob Ross painting, watching people do stuff Absolutely. Like that, because they know what they're doing. The electricians are up there. I don't even want to twist the yellow and black and white wires anymore on the ceiling fan. I have to call a dude for that. I'll call a lady if I have to. Whoever does it, because you have skills.
That's right.
I just wish I'd studied more of it. I've been putting off for the last 3 days getting under my sink in the bathroom, and turning off the hot water, taking off the handle, so I can put a washer in.
Who has better work hands? Let's take a look.
Work hands.
Who's got
them old linebacker hands?
Work. Calluses. Roger was complaining about calluses working out the other day.
Yeah. Well, I did. So I wear gloves. I wear gloves on any of them because I go home and I go, hey,
well, it was funny.
I need lotion. There's some other lotion on my hand.
Today is national. We have these days, and I'll go over them in a second. It's National Lineman Appreciation Day. What do you think?
We're a lineman for the county, and we drive the main road.
Yeah, so that's what, or we could,
or
go
could it be?
the best lineman for the Razorbacks.
That's
it, could be
either
one.
We could do that either way.
It's also, let me go ahead and mention this, it's National Colonist Day. It's National Animal Crackers Day.
All right.
You remember as kids that the animal crackers, that was a big deal?
Do you know what they've done to the animal box?
Oh, no. Oh, yeah. They took off the
took
circus.
Took off the cages.
Yes.
They took them out of cages.
Do you remember the
animal
cracker?
Giraffe.
That's what it was.
You always hated because if there was a gorilla, the head was off.
It's National Exercise Day, which is something that you do better than me. It's National Auctioneers Day. This is what Roger likes to do.
Hey, look up Leroy Van Dyke.
Well, we've got a couple local guys. Yeah. I'll mention in a second. It's also National High Five Day. You know what's been? You know what's pushed out the high five?
Yeah,
the fist bump. Yeah. The fist bump has pushed out the high five. Nobody does the high five. Nobody does open palm.
And you know what? Well, and COVID accentuated even more so the bump.
I know.
You got rid of shaking hands.
It's also national.
Get back to it.
It's International Jugglers Day. No juggling here today. That will not be. Although there have been people who've had a career out of juggling things. You're a juggler.
You're a career juggler.
No, I'm not.
You are. I mean, you got 17 things.
Yeah, well, that's true, but not in my hands. It's also, and finally, it's national. Now, I want to make sure I say this right because it's in the clip. Velociraptor Day.
Yeah.
Now, what Velociraptor, the one in Step Brothers where they go?
Yes.
Maybe your favorite. Josh, if you can find that.
Isn't that the one that killed Newman in the first Jurassic Park?
When its thing gets wide at the end?
Isn't that the one that did that one?
Yeah, that the T-Rex did.
T-Rex didn't get Newman.
Yeah.
When he had the can of
shaving cream. The thing went wide with his gills.
Because he was running away with the sample, the blood, or the DNA and all that. See how we just...
we are here at the Conway Expo Center. Not many people know this is a big darn facility out here.
It's huge.
I've spoken out here. I emceed an event, and I didn't recognize it when I came out here because it's got so much... You got indoor-outdoor space, and this is a very useful thing, obviously provided by the city of Conway. What time do all the students start arriving?
We'll have the students start getting here at 8:30, and they'll come in waves, so we'll have shifts of students. We don't want all 900 getting here at one time.
Are you confident that you have this under control, or that it might not be just chaos?
Absolutely confident that we have it under control.
Well, because I was asking, you mentioned you have four teams. Does everybody know coming in what time they go to whatever booth and – is it just sort of walk up and do it?
I just walk up and do it, and it is chaos.
I'm just telling you, which is okay. Our show is Morning Mayhem. We're controlled.
You've seen it in person.
We're chaos anyway. So
what about two things? Whenever I go to a golf tournament, you expect to get a goodie bag. When you come to an expo, you expect a goodie bag. Maybe a pencil and paper and pad. Do you have goodie bags here?
They're getting a table.
You're gonna get the table. You will build stuff and get
that. That's right.
Yes, anything you do, you get to
even better.
You'll see these kids carrying these coffee tables on the bus.
I did see there's a screwdriving contest. Now, how does that work?
That's not for bartenders.
Yeah, they have all kinds of different contests here.
Bill, you know what I do? I think of zzz, zzz, you know.
That's it.
Is it old school or is it when it comes to
talking about hand? You don't. Yeah.
It's zip zip. It's not the old school.
Okay.
No more old school. Yeah,
you know what?
Everybody's got a junk drawer. You've got paper clips, trash can tie. You have a screwdriver. And listen, when we were kids, you had to have both of them. Now there is a one for the star and flathead.
The kids today even have the ability. Once you, what do you call when you strip a screw out where you, it reverses it. You know what? Back in the old day, you were
screwed.
Yeah, that's right.
You're screwed.
Way to go. But now you got the magic screw thing that reverses it out of there.
People here can fix that stripped hole and put it back together.
If you went to our webcam and saw, it's not just me and Roger, it's Sheila Burrows with Nab Holtz and Bill Rochelle, who is the president of the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. Yeah, these are all the notable names in Arkansas, a lot of them that are here today. So I guess you guys feel it's important enough to be here as well.
Oh, absolutely. We're here to support our community. Hey, you joked earlier about, you know, recruiting people. We absolutely will, you know, have that potential to recruit somebody to come work for us.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. Well,
and the other part of it is like outdoors people, the folks here that are putting on the demonstration and all that, they love what they do. So mm-hmm. they enjoy teaching somebody that skill because it is a skill. And if you can do this, you can survive. I can't survive. We never know what goes on. I think there was one time we almost panicked and starved to death when the microwave went out. I thought, oh my God, we don't know how much use it until it's gone. Not that my wife and mother-in-law, they use the stove. But I mean, with something like that, I don't know how to do it. I wouldn't know how to put a new one in.
Well,
I'm just telling on myself.
The event is building my future, which is great. Listen, kids need this. You know, back in the old day, we didn't have this, we didn't have this kind of opportunity. So
I want to know the difference between a 220 and 220.
We'll let you test it.
Yeah, thank you, Bill.
All right. We'll have you guys jump back on here a little bit later. It is a 6:45. If you want to be a part of the show, 661-1037 is our text line, our D3 auto text line. And we'll be back in just a minute.
Life isn't just about living, it's about living well. And no one understands that better than Baptist Health. Baptist Health is there to support you in your wellness journey wherever it may take you. They really are so much more than a healthcare provider. They're a true partner coming alongside you to help you live your fullest, healthiest life. From pediatrics to women's health to cardiac care to orthopedics to primary care, they offer the full spectrum of services you need to keep yourself and your whole family healthy, no matter what phase of life you're in. And you can always count on the care you receive at Baptist Health to be exceptional and compassionate. Listen, they're Arkansas's most trusted name in healthcare for a reason. For more than a century, Baptist Health has helped countless Arkansans create the healthy lives they deserve. And I know they can do the same for you. I know from experience the level of commitment they have for their patients. I've been a Baptist Health patient for decades, and I'm always in good hands. Their level of care is exceptional. Remember, life isn't just about living. It's about living well, and no one understands that better than Baptist Health. Ready to take the next step in your wellness journey? Visit Baptist-Health.com. Baptist Health, for you, for life.
The $79 garage door tune-up extended through April. Is your garage door too loud? Is it whining for attention? Overhead Door Company of Little Rock will make it all better. They'll perform their garage door tune-up and safety inspection for just $79 extended through April. That's just $79 for up to 3 garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now? And for just $79, schedule now at overheaddoorofLittleRock.com.
Whoa, Howie, that's a lot of diamonds. What's going on?
We're about to launch the biggest natural loose diamond event we've had in the history of Robert Irwin Jewelers.
Any shape, any size?
Yes, natural loose diamonds for any budget. Plus, get a free men's wedding band with every natural loose diamond purchase. 0% interest for up to 5 years. See a store for complete details.
It's the biggest natural loose diamond and bridal event this weekend at the West Little Rock location in the Pleasant Ridge Town Center.
Robert Irwin Jewelers, home of the meant to be guarantee, upgrades are welcome.
This is the Pigskin Preacher bringing you the word. The legendary black evangelist Marshall Keeble said, "When a man is ready to obey the gospel, all the devils in hell can't hold him back." I thought of this when I recently had the privilege of baptizing my friend Everett, who has a tracheostomy, meaning that he breathes through a tube into his windpipe. Did I mention that he was baptized by immersion? Watching his determination that day was truly inspiring. Everett's example reminds us that life is fleeting and that we need to do good while we have the opportunity. Double B's ask you for the opportunity to earn your trust by providing friendly, fast, competent service for your busy life. Come by and stock up on the things that you need. Double B's, it's where you get it, grab it, and go.
you know, that one. You do that. I forget what that one is. So I'll just do it for them.
We are.
And that's what I want to tell Trey Reed and Doug Snyder. If I do this, you may not like it, but my grandkids know that's a turkey.
Big article in the Democrat Gazette today about turkey hunting. We'll hopefully have that happen with me here soon. Yes. We are here at Build My Future in the Conway Expo Center. It's brought to you by the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. It's going to be really cool. Let me tell you what. I'm just telling you, I had to ask them that. It is freestyle. Kids are going to come in here, and they're going to go. They're going to gravitate to whatever. And so it's not really organized to the fact that, you know, yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it's going to be interesting to watch.
Well, somebody's going to gravitate. Listen, the first thing I noticed was the studs with the electrical and all that kind of stuff. Because I would like to put an electrical outlet.
I know.
I'd like to put one somewhere.
Would you ever trust yourself to do it?
No.
Didn't you used to do your own ceiling fans?
I used to do my own ceiling
fan. How did you do that? How did you trust yourself doing a ceiling fan? Ceiling fans are very difficult because it's uneven. If you get it warbles.
Just to replace one. Now, I didn't wire it or anything like that. I'd put a new one up there. How did I do that?
You know, guys who can, or ladies who can put in a
outlet.
The outlet. Put in the outlet. It's so impressive. Well, because, and you tie things up.
Well, because, you know what, when you sell your house and all that, and one of these days we're going to talk about the folks that come out and check your house. Not the investigator, but whatever it is, they got who? The inspector. Yeah. I want to have an inspector talk one of these days because I know that's a money making thing. Anyway, so when they come in, and if you don't have the right outlet in your bathroom or kitchen, it's got to have this and that. I could put one in myself if
I know. I know.
But I didn't do it.
We had to pay the man.
I got
to
pay the man.
Which is more expensive. Here's what it says. With the amount of folks talking about National High Five Day, with the amount of folks who don't wash their hands after using the bathroom, I have no problems with the high five and handshake going away. You know, can I tell you what, too? I'm seeing this a lot.
I'm with that person.
Okay, I'm seeing this a lot. You're coming up to people, and we are having trouble as men. That's right. Yeah, it's very awkward.
Yeah,
Do we not want to shake hands anymore?
I do.
Okay,
I want to shake a hand.
I have no problem.
I will extend my hand right off the bat.
Yes,
unless I do see that person who just got through picking their nose or coming out of the bathroom, I'm gonna. You know what? I might even go, "Hey, what's up?"
You are more alert to hand germs than most.
I shouldn't be.
I think God made our bodies to be able to process a lot. Yeah, I think so.
I understand.
Yes.
But you know what?
Oh, my gosh. You're talking about an old COVID term.
Exactly. Here's the other part. And God made us, made a soap. Man invent soap. To go, you know what? It's kind of nasty in there.
That is true.
Listen, it takes a particular set of skills to be able to flush and open a door with your feet.
That's true. Coming up shortly, we'll visit with Joe Klein. We'll visit with Tommy Smith, Melinda Mayo. Will McIntyre a little bit later in the show. Alicia Dover is here with us. Remember her from Channel 7, her days there.
I remember.
Somebody also, too, made mention is National Exercise Day, something that I would love to be able to start doing here soon. Yeah. If you missed it early in the show, Razorbacks do win last night, 5-4 against Texas Tech. Because that's
fun game to watch.
25 wins in a row now, Baum Walker, which is outstanding. That was a very worthwhile. You guys will talk with Will McIntyre today, talking about the importance of.
There was a dropped ball in the infield. The sun got in the way, and it made me think of the World Series.
I know.
Because the sun is up there. And I think it was Stonewall that made
it. Is that right? Did you see the great catch he made there?
Absolutely.
Well, the other big news was that this show talked about, as a matter of fact, Josh, you even put it on the question of the day, should Coach Van Horn be bunting more? And so people are going, we're going to let Coach Van Horn do what he wants to do, which, of course, but Dave Van Horn listened to Morning Mayhem yesterday and bunted twice, not once, twice.
Smart move.
How about that? It was sort of eerie.
I saw people yesterday were like, you guys just trying to find something to complain about. Teams, so good. And honestly, we weren't complaining. We were just
an observation.
Yeah, honestly, it was a good observation. I thought, and hey, guess what? They bunted yesterday.
Not once, but twice. And even Justin said it was eerie.
that was really strange. That was incredibly strange.
We talked about they have not bunted. I can't remember if they
did last
year.
I can't think about it a lot this year.
Not once. Right. Yeah. And so anyway, so Arkansas wins. They'll play. They've got South Carolina this weekend, right? I think that's the series.
Do. Yes.
Yeah. Is that home?
No, Columbia.
Columbia. And then you've got the Trojans last night beating Central Arkansas. Great to see the Governor's I-40 showdown. They went 8-4 in a late inning grand slam for the Trojans there. The ladies for the Razorbacks gymnastics team will compete today in the NCAA Gymnastics Championships. I think, I don't know where that's at. If that's a West Coast, I'm not sure where that's at. And Big Z sign, Zvonimir Ivicic signed with the Razorbacks yesterday, so it is official. I think he could be a big NIL guy. So it was interesting. I was talking with Pat Bradley yesterday, Roger. There's a chance. There is a very good chance that we will, as long as Calipari is there at Arkansas, we will never have another Razorback NIL call with a Razorback basketball player because they'll all be too expensive.
Oh, you think so?
There's a good chance.
Really?
We'll see.
I thought you were going to say we wouldn't be able to understand
them. No. I think it's good for the kids to do these and not just make it about money. Make a little bit of money. Don't worry about you got enough other big deals. But it's good to do media training.
Well, we saw what it did. Listen, I think KJ got too big for us.
Oh, he did.
Because we had KJ. So that's also one other thing. Yeah. But it's also great practice if you want to go into another field
too.
Get out as well to be around other folks.
Zvonimir, what do you have to say about that?
I love it.
Zvonimir, you do?
I like the way you do it because it makes me think of Hunt for Red October.
Zvonimir. Yeah. Zvonimir. Yes. Remember how they went from the...
I know the scene. Fort Worth. On the ground, and it came up and went English.
Yeah. Fort Worth for gymnastics.
Fort Worth. Okay, thank you, Josh. All right, Joe Cloud coming up next. We're here in Conway. It's the first ever Build My Future event. Don't go away. 7 o'clock.
Where real men come to play.
Our number one station is right.
If you want to rock, you got to break the rules.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at AlcoaCommunityFCU.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Red tape. 1 in 3 businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
Get your popcorn ready. We've got the entertainment right here on 103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with KARK's Claire Kreitz.
4 men were arrested for a shooting that killed 1 person and hurt 9 others in Wynn. Pavarius Millen, Carl Washington, Cameron Crawford, and Tommy Frost are facing several charges, including first-degree murder. Arkansas legislators are working to amend the state's current crypto mining law. 2 of the 8 resolutions presented on the House floor passed yesterday. The current law allows local governments to have control over crypto mining sites and put a stop to them. The resolutions passed aim to expand that, giving the city and county governments control over the sites once they're built. An Arkansas woman received a national award for her work following the tornado that hit Wynn last year. Leanne Lovell founded the Wynn Relief and Recovery Organization. She established a distribution center, brought in doctors and counselors, and secured temporary housing. This is Claire Kreitz for the Buzz Radio Network.
The United Cerebral Palsy Putt-Putt Club Crawl is coming April 27th to Little Rock's River Market. To register your 4-person team, text UCP-PUB to 41444.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center. Buzz Weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too, a high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special, dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, 2 sides, and our famous salad bar, only $60. Good. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Tune in each week to Out of Bounds to hear from team captain Kendall Diggs. Omaha is the goal, and we're looking for a great season. Kendall Diggs is brought to you by Stephen Elmore with Shelter Insurance. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, see shelter agent Stephen Elmore or give him a call at 501-537-0959.
You've heard about the thousands of patients finally getting relief from chronic joint pain thanks to QC Kinetics non-invasive treatments. And here's one who was determined to avoid surgery. Meet Vicky.
The orthopedic surgeon said, well, you're going to need knee replacement sooner rather than later. I kept hearing commercials about QC Kinetics and thought, well, I'm going to check them out first.
QC Kinetics has treated over 20,000 patients like Vicky around the country. People who were told they needed surgery but chose a more natural, less invasive approach that uses regenerative treatment to help heal and restore painful joints with no downtime.
If QC Kinetics had not been what I expected, I would have gone through with the surgery, but I got so much relief, am now pretty much pain-free that I don't have to have the surgery.
Before going under the knife, you need to check out QC Kinetics. The consultation is free. Call today.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Smith & Wesson revolvers are built to suit the demands of the most serious firearms enthusiast. And for a limited time at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart, receive a $50 rebate on Smith & Wesson J-frame revolvers or a $75 rebate on Smith & Wesson K-frame, L-frame, N-frame, and Governor revolvers. This offer expires April 30th, so hurry before time runs out. Max Prairie Wings, with the best selection, the most competitive prices, and all the ammo you need. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today or online at maxpw.com.
Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool & Spa 20% off store-wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakusil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool & Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store-wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool & Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.
Hi, it's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. Folks, if you're shopping for a new car or truck, I hope you'll come see us and give us a chance to earn your business. We have huge discounts, 0% financing available, and we'll give you $1,000 over Kelley Blue Book value for your trade-in. Folks, I guarantee you a hassle-free buying experience. And if you've had credit problems in the past, listen to this. We have an easy pre-approval process. Just go to FletcherCredit.com to get started. You can be pre-approved in minutes. It's really not hard. FletcherCredit.com. Folks, we're also still buying cars every day. If you got an old car or truck you want to turn into cash, bring it to Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood and ask for Chris or Andy. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Shop in person or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Thank you.
Pickup truck, sports car, motorcycle, minivan, townhouse, two-story, farmhouse, fixer-upper. What you drive and where you live is different for everyone, so it's important to have insurance that fits your needs and is just right for you. At Shelter Insurance, we understand that, which is why our agents help you design a comprehensive auto, home, and life insurance plan. Insurance that fits just right.
See shelter agent Matt Steele in Bryant, Todd Matthews in Benton, or Justin Stewart in Malvern today.
Mark your calendar for the Criminal Justice Institute Strikeout Opioids Day at the Arkansas Travelers Game on April 20th. Explore the Arkansas Overdose Prevention Program booth for essential prevention resources and learn about naloxone. Dive deeper at narcansaw.com.
This is Pat Bradley. Tune in every Tuesday when I join Justin and Wes in the Zone. Brought to you by River City Flooring. Visit RiverCityFlooringInc.com, RiverCityFlooringInc.com.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
If I can change.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
And you can change.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Everybody can change.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, it is 7:06 on this Thursday, April 18th. Morning Mayhem on the road again. Yesterday we were in Conway at Luxury Pool & Spa. Thanks to them for their hospitality and for all the folks who are customers there. And then we're back in Conway at the Conway Expo Center for the Build My Future event brought to you by the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. Really unique event. We'll talk more about it coming up shortly. 1,200 students here will learn all kind of interesting or be exposed to a lot of career opportunities or possibilities, and it's a hands-on kind of deal. And I would have loved to have had this, Raj, back when we were young.
I think I would have, too. At least old Roger thinks younger Roger would have.
Yeah, I think he would have.
A couple things. Leonard Skinner, defense from our buddy Michael Marion. Leonard Skinner, ZZ Top tonight. Expect around 7,000 to 8,000. That's a good crowd. We were talking. Somebody said there's nobody left with Leonard Skinner. We'll have to ask Justin that when he joins us here shortly.
Yeah,
somebody says, y'all are kidding me. An outlet is two wires. Come on. Maybe.
Is that a teenage girl bagging us? You got to go outside, turn off the power.
Yeah.
Make sure you know which one it is. Go back and forth. I'll hear Samantha going, you don't know what you're doing. Don't do it. Don't do it.
I know. Don't get shocked.
Don't do it.
Last one, Ethan B. says, amen for Nabholz. I work for them. It's a great company. We're working on the new community center here in Conway.
Nice.
So there you go.
Well, I mean, Nabholz, surely they have done stuff.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
There's
They've been around for 75 years.
That
crane
has been around. I've seen it somewhere.
Razorbacks win, as I mentioned earlier, 5-4 against Texas Tech last night. The Trojans beat UCA 8-4. Hog Gymnastics is today. And the big man, Big Z, signs today with the Hogs. Speaking of big man, let's check in with our man, Joe Klein. Josh?
They call him Big Joe from Slater Mole. He is a 7-foot man, muscle and meat. One of the leading scorers in Razorback history, Big Joe led the Hogs to an amazing 75% winning percentage, including a historic win against number one Michael Jordan and North Carolina. He captured Olympic gold, then added an NBA world title with MJ and the Chicago Bulls. Big Joe actually played with as many NBA teams as Tom Brady won Super Bowls. But who's counting? He loves Westerns and worships Barry Manilow. Now representing Corky's Ribs and Barbecue, Joe Klein.
Good morning, Joe. Joe, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
You know, I heard yesterday for the first time, Roger, Joe Klein's intro for The Zone.
Oh.
Not bad.
I didn't know he
had it. I want to ask you, which intro do you like better, ours or theirs?
Wow.
It's way too long. Of a
there's
him.
Just...
No. It's way too long for him to answer.
Yeah, he did pause for a while.
It's still paused.
Yeah, I mean, no, I like them both. Equally the same. They're both done with love. They both were done with love and care, and I appreciate them both.
Yeah, have you heard it, Roger?
No, I'd like to hear it, Josh, if you could find it. But listen, if I may speak for Joe, and I usually do, he doesn't. He'd prefer not even having them on. He really wouldn't.
Have not what on?
The
intros?
Intros, yeah.
Justin Anchory didn't like that?
No,
Joe Klein.
Joe does not. He's too humble.
Well, yesterday, Joe has been with us so long, Roger, in the morning show, that it's starting to affect his ability to recall correct sports names. Yes, he was talking about his time with the New Jersey Nets with Coach Cal yesterday, and he talked about the great forward, Turner Gill, who played for the Nets. But actually, Turner Gill was the starting quarterback on the national championship Nebraska Cornhuskers. Kevin Kelly had to point that out to him.
Ooh.
So, Joe.
I know that bird.
it does happen, doesn't it, every once in a while?
Well, it's like you tell your little kids when you grow up, you hang around stupid people. And you're going to become one yourself. So you hang around with bad people, bad things happen. I'll just leave it at that.
Kendall Gill was the person you were thinking about. And I love what you said. It was because Coach Cal at the press conference said, you're the one who got him fired. You said he was much bigger than you. The troubles he had Nets were much bigger than Joe Klein.
I had an influence in the NBA, but nobody could have had the influence that the New Jersey, they're still bad, David.
I know. They're cursed. We were talking yesterday, Joe. By the way, it is Thursday. Go ahead and get you right off the bat. What is happening today on
Burgers?
Burgers Day. Okay.
Well, we got good burgers, special on burgers. Had a burger the other day. We have a tremendous burger. It's good as anything in town. I love our hamburgers.
Discount
love
burgers.
Them.
All right. Yeah. The other thing, Joe, we were talking the other day because obviously it's now official.
Zvonimir Isevic signed with the Razorbacks yesterday. We were talking about the best seven-footers to play at Arkansas. I'm talking about legit seven-foot-plus players. You're just a hair under seven-foot. There really haven't been a lot of seven-footers that have been
dominant players. I mean, legit seven footers. Can you recall off the top of your head maybe the ones that you thought were the best? Arkansas?
Seven footers?
Yep.
Mike Carpenter.
I remember him.
He was not a dominant player.
I know. How tall was he? Was he seven four?
How tall was he?
Yeah, he was 7'2", but he was the first time I'd ever heard about, is it called skerplunking, where you go into caves?
Yes, yes.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, yes.
That was the first time I'd ever heard that phrase, and he liked to do that.
Oh, gosh.
7'2".
Oh, that's nuts.
I mean, I think it's really the only one I can think of. Stephen Hill was
played in the NBA
for a little bit. I think got drafted by Portland.
Do you remember Joe?
I can't.
Rick Schaefer brought him up, and I don't know if you remember him or not, Joe. But I made the joke. We were out at practice. I remember I was on the field practicing with the Razorbacks, and this tall dude. He was a black dude, and he was, I could tell he was 7 feet.
I know exactly. I told
my buddy, I said, look at him. I said, that dude can barely walk. I said, there's no way he's going to be able to play for Eddie. There's no, this kid can, I think it was Eddie at the time. I said, there's no way. And sure enough, I don't, what was it? Shamir or Jeer? What was his name? What was it?
Shahid Ali.
Did he ever see a minute on the court? Did he ever get on the court?
No, he ended up transferring. He transferred to us, and then he transferred to a smaller school. I don't remember.
Yeah. Well, it goes to show you, Roger, we don't have the 7-footer. Yeah. And that we're getting a guy, Joe, that comes in. And this guy, he's 7'2", 234, from Croatia. The NCAA didn't allow him to play the first half of the season. He comes in, he averages almost 6 points, almost 4 rebounds, a couple blocks a game, and 11 minutes per game. Against us, I didn't realize this, Raj. Against us in Lexington, 12 points, 9 rebounds, 2 blocks, 1 assist, and 1 steal in their 111-102 win over us. What do you think about him as a player, what you've been able to see, Joe?
Very skilled. A very, very skilled player. Can do some things. Kind of your conventional big man nowadays. Can shoot it a little bit from after the 3. Decent 3-point shooter. Can put it on the floor. Good passer, but really good finesse player. Got a lot of skill. Very, very good player. Good upside. If he gets, I think the one thing he lacks right now, he's got to get a little bit better with his footwork to stay out of foul trouble and just maneuver himself a little bit. And then, he, as most young European players do, I think he lacks a little toughness, needs to be a little tougher, rebound, do a little of the dirty work things that seven-footers, you need to do that really help your team. I mean, I think a lot of times skilled guys get too caught up in scoring and passing and dribbling and doing all the stuff that make people go like that. Look at that big guy doing that. And then they get away from what the team needs. And the team needs shot blocking, rebounding, offensive rebounding, kind of gritness. And so he has the ability to do that. I mean, he has the ability to be play for a long time and make a lot of money. Just needs a few little things, but it's a great get. Really good player.
Two things, Joe, and hopefully I'll remember the second one. First is, why do you say European players are soft? You got another example, or do they play roughhousing in Europe?
It's just a different kind of. It's kind of been ahead of American basketball in that they kind of were a 3-point shooting emphasis on running up and down, opening the floor up, spreading the offense. They were ahead of their time. They were ahead of American ball because they didn't have back in the day when you played a lot of post players and you played through the post and you had big 7-footers and bangers and things like that. Europe didn't seem to have that type of player. They had more of a finesse skilled player, so they adjusted their style to play that way. And now it's kind of evolved to where, you know, more so that way over here.
I didn't
What's
know.
Your second question?
You just, I didn't know. I didn't hear you stop.
Am I bothering you?
Well, you did okay? Go a little bit longer. You did go on a little bit longer. But listen, you're our guest. I'm not going to stop you right there. So it sounds like Connor Vanover could do well in Europe with his three-point skill.
Maybe he goes to Europe.
If he does something like that. On the other hand, so that, and then that goes back to this cat. Coming in and being a traditional tall guy, because growing up, all I remember, I mean, obviously remember you, Joe. I mean, you were, I don't know how much older you are than me. When I was a kid, I remember, Andrew Lang. Twin Towers with Lee Wilson.
Somebody said Jason
Robinson,
Jason Jennings. You recognize that name?
I do remember Jason Jennings.
Yeah.
Sure.
Is he a 7-footer?
He ended up. Yeah. He was out of Bald Knob, I believe.
That's right. I forgot about him.
He ended up playing at Arkansas State.
Yeah.
He's a good player.
We may have a second Joe Klein fumble.
Uh-oh, yeah?
So somebody says here, let me see where it says. It says, Joe, cave exploration is called – let me get this right. It's called splunking.
Yeah,
not kerplunking.
I wouldn't want to say that. No. I knew where Joe was going with that
one. Whoever, hey,
yeah.
Whoever corrected me on that, crawl back in your cave.
or do you mean spelunk back in your cave? But no, I know what Joe was saying. Joe was hearing the sound he makes from his bidet.
The other thing we wanted to talk to you, by the way, if you just joined, it is a burger day at Corky's. Either location, they'll cut you a deal on a great burger. The other thing, Joe, obviously the big news yesterday in the NBA, you had for the first time ever, a player has been banned for the rest of his life. Jontay Porter, who was a Missouri, obviously a Tiger in college, banned for life for gambling. What are your thoughts on that? And surprise, probably happened before, just caught her. What's your thought?
I mean, just, you know, you're stupid. You know, you got what you deserved. I mean, it's just, you can't, I mean, like you hear some of this stuff sometimes and you go, you cannot believe that you're going to get away with stuff like that. I mean, the way they monitor this stuff and are on top of this stuff, and it's probably harder now, David, to do something than when we played.
Right, that's right.
Because now they are aware and they watch it and you know, they stay on top of it and they notice trends.
Yep, that's right.
He got what he deserved.
The other part, by the way, Justin Moore joins us. Good morning, JM. How are you?
I'm good, guys. How are y'all?
We're good. The other thing about that is that, I don't know if it was Roger or Josh made the point, you know, it was not a superstar. So you didn't have the NBA. I mean, it was an easy call for the NBA to say bye.
Sure.
You know, it's a high profile guy.
Speaking of, would they have done that to, let's say, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, just for example?
Justin, as in everything, you know, you hope they would, you know,
in a perfect world
that we live in, it. Yeah. But I mean, he's a different level. So I mean, I would hope they would, but I don't know.
You know,
trumps trouble.
People are treated differently in this world, and a lot of it depends on, you know, where you're at, what you can do. But I mean, you would hope that they would. It would be very, very severe. I can tell you that for sure. And again, you hope it would be the same.
Well,
I know that it would be at the minimum, there would be years involved in his band.
Well,
so, yeah.
the other thing, he's obviously got a problem with to put your career on the line for, you know, I mean, you really, really, you're multi-millionaire. I mean, you've got this career in front of you, and you blow it because of this. I mean, obviously, he's got a gambling addiction.
Right, and he got away with it. If you can get away with doing $10
but
today,
why risk it?
I because mean, you want more money.
I know, obviously, but why risk your now he's
you, you know, he didn't think he's going to get caught.
So let's see if Joe. Let's see.
What I read, I mean, he won like a total. Of like,
yeah, not much.
50 something.
Yeah, not much. Yeah.
You're an NBA player.
Yep, yeah, I know. Really?
What if he's not a star? He's not getting money. Let's see if Joe.
You betcha. He's a millionaire. Let's see if Joe can get this. Joe, he becomes only the second person in NBA history to be banned for life after.
History?
Did I say that? I'm sorry. Listen, I'm finding a stuffed up nose. history. He's the second to be banned from the NBA. Who was the other? Is for violating league rules.
Turner Gill.
No, Roger got it. Justin, who was it? Justin, you want to take a shot?
My guess is I don't know the name, but that referee.
No, that was it. That's a good guess. That is not it. Roger actually.
I thought two.
Roger actually got it. Roger, you
want to? Yeah. Here's the deal. Roger actually got it. It's like I'm that monkey with cymbals.
Well, that was not an easy get.
No, it's not. Donald Sterling. Donald Sterling is who it was.
Yeah, Roger actually.
Well, this is a tough one. Well, Joe's an NBA player and he didn't get it.
Justin, you know who I am to this show, don't you?
Who was it?
Donald Sterling.
Donald Sterling.
Donald Sterling. Yeah, Donald Sterling. Justin. Justin, you know who I am?
No, I just said person. I said person.
Yeah,
yeah, you got to be paying attention.
Yeah, you don't pay attention.
No.
You said player.
Now listen,
yeah, Justin, I am the Fredo of this show, Justin. I'm smart. Like they say. No, listen, Donald Sterling. And again, let's talk about privilege. I think Joe's brothers would admit that the All-American, he got a little special privilege, you know, because he was
the
good.
The All-American.
Because he was good. Let's get the All-American. Let's blame it on the other guy.
Joe, by the way, too, I don't know if you've heard, but Coach Cal has got his new ops guy for Central Arkansas. His name is Tommy Bones.
Tommy Bones is who I am, Joey.
So, what's your number one priority, Tommy Bones?
My number one priority for the next couple of weeks. Now, I'm not going to waste a lot of time on this one. We've got to get some serious, true Italian food in the Little Rock metro area.
Not enough Italian food.
But not for me. Not for Coach Kyle. And listen, Joey, we will come to your place and sign autographs. $50,000 wow. is all I need first.
Wow.
Anything above and beyond that, you'll give it to the kids.
Hey, Mr. Bones.
Yes.
Mr. Bones.
Okay, well, you meet me out by the dumpster. We'll have small bills. And we'll have them in an envelope for you, and we can get that done.
You're making me cry.
Justin, what were you saying?
I was just wondering, what if you know, he's looking for an Italian restaurant to open up. What if we get, you know, 3-4 good Italian dishes added to the Corky's menu?
Yeah.
Well, you know, that would be fantastic.
Justin, you know what we're going to do?
What are you going to do?
You know what we're going to do for Tom? You know what we're going to do for Tommy Bones? This day on. Corky, from now on, we're changing the sign. It's going to be Corky's with an I.
Corky's with an
I. I see what he did there.
I like it.
I see what he did. No disrespect there, like, Joey. Let
I
me
like
tell
it.
You something.
Corky's
You're
with
a good
an
kid.
I.
Listen, we made a lot of money on you when you were at Notre Dame. You know, we bet some money on you at Notre Dame. Back in the day. You're a good kid, Joey. You've always been a good kid, and you've always respected what we do. And I appreciate you very much. And remember what I said. Instead of calamari, what we want to do at your place is have some calamari. All right, that's what we call it. Calamari.
Hey, Corky's with an I, some calamari coming.
There it is.
All right, I like it.
All
I
right,
like
Joe.
Thanks, group.
Near you.
Thanks,
Joe. Appreciate it.
We love you, Joe.
Go
finish your spelunking.
Justin, this is the way it's supposed to go to break on our show, where the music is not turned up so loud that you're getting drowned out. We'll have to play that clip again. That's it. That's from yesterday.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
All right, we'll come back here at the Build My Future event, the Conway Expo Center.
Brought to you by Floyd Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season, and Floyd's has live Louisiana crawfish. Order by 1 p.m. Thursday for weekend boils. Floyd's, meatandseafood.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Night number two of the NBA postseason is in the books. The Philadelphia 76ers are the seventh seed in the Eastern Conference. They beat the Miami Heat 105-104. It was 23 points and 15 rebounds for Joel Embiid, 19 points for Tyrese Maxey, and 20 points for Nicholas Batum off the bench. Miami will host Chicago. The Bulls beat the Atlanta Hawks last night 131-116 to win the second play-in game. A great evening for Coby White, who had 42 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists, 22 points and 12 boards for Nikola Vucevic, and then 22 points, 9 assists, and 6 boards for DeMar DeRozan. The Bulls and the Heat will meet on Friday night. The winner of that game will play the number one seed Boston Celtics in round number one. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too, a high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special, dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, two sides, and our famous salad bar, only $60. Good Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Tickets are on sale now for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Go to buzzbq.com to get yours. Sample lots of great barbecue and visit with your favorite Buzz personalities. It's the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, sponsored by Michelob Ultra, Gravely Mowers, Oaklawn Hot Springs, Tito's Handmade Vodka, Lion Legal, Jez Camper Rental, and LRS, benefiting Ronald McDonald House Charities of Arkansas and North Louisiana.
Hey, it's David Basil for Simmons Bank. You've heard me say over and over again how much I love being a Simmons Bank customer and learning about their amazing success story, starting with one little Pine Bluff bank in 1903 and now celebrating their 120th banking birthday. They have become one of the fastest growing banks in America. 120 years in banking, that's a ton of experience. The reason Simmons Bank has been around for 12 decades is because they have a track record of helping people turn their goals into plans. And that's worth repeating. Simmons Bank knows how to help their customers turn their goals into plans. And they're ready to talk to you now, but first, they'll listen. Simmons Bank will guide you at every step. No matter what's next in your life, Simmons Bank wants to make financing the easiest decision you make. A personal loan from Simmons Bank could be the solution you need for large purchases like home improvement projects, wedding expenses, vacations, emergency expenses, or an automobile, boat, or RV purchase. Don't wait any longer. Let Simmons Bank help change your financial life.
The king of Arkansas sports talk, Randy Rainwater, for Bet Saracen.
In Arkansas, 7 out of every $10 placed on a sporting bet app is with Bet Saracen, because Bet Saracen offers more ways to win and more ways to get paid and faster. Find your winners on Bet Saracen and look for my double R prop bet specials. I pick them and you win them.
Bet Saracen is Arkansas's favorite sports wagering app.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. Working hard once again, making sure my lawn is lush, weed-free, and beautiful. And by working hard, I mean, of course, I'm watching Bradley Owens mow it for me. Bradley, tell the good folks hello.
Hey, everybody, how's it going?
Stop right there, Bradley. I don't want you to stop what you're doing. What he didn't tell you is that you can take your very own Gravely Mower home today at 0% interest over 48 months. That's right, 0% interest on both residential and commercial mowers. Now, Bradley, tell them where they can go to get the very own Gravely Mower.
Well, you go.
That's enough, my friend. I'll finish it for you at MPE in Sheridan or Gravel Ridge Small Engine in Jacksonville.
Hey, everybody. This is NFL Hall of Famer Dan Hampton, and I love hanging out with Paz and the boys on the Buzz. Tune in every morning so you can get the news just like I do.
Pitch on the way. A drive by Stovall to right field. The Hogs take the lead on the first swing by Peyton Stovall. A homer to the Hunt Center. Pretty good start. 1-0 Razorbacks in the first. Walk two of them, allowed a hit to another. 2-2. Swung on, line caught, second base, Stovall, easy double play. Woodcox was halfway to second base. Rack him up. One out to go.
All right. Nice win for the Razorbacks. Nice two-game series win for the Razorbacks. They beat Texas Tech last night 5-4. You know, Justin, you know, it could have really easily turned there. You know, you lose two back-to-back against Bama. You're down 7-0 against Texas Tech. I heard Bubba Carpenter talking about it. Man, you lose that game, and all of a sudden you just lose a little bit of your mojo. And the way they came back and won, you know, two nights ago, and then they sort of gutted their way through last night's win. I think it's a positive. I think it came at the right time, and I think they, you know, sort of got their you know, mind back on track if it wasn't on track after Alabama.
Yeah, those are the type wins that that really help you in, like, the RPI.
Yep, yep.
When they're selecting, I mean, obviously we're going to be in a tournament, but
yeah,
when you're talking about being a national top eight seed, those types of things, those are the type games that really help midweek.
Yep.
That, you know, maybe a lot of other teams are not playing. And
that's
maybe,
right.
You know, we're probably going to be that regardless, but you know, it always helps to just keep stacking them up, man.
Thanks, Trey. And we'll also too, we've got a couple of guests here, but we'll come back, circle back and talk about the bunting yesterday, which was absolutely fascinating.
I mean, we'll come back. Yeah. But I'm sitting there going,
I know.
All right. This is weird.
Yeah, I know.
Did somebody tell him?
I know. It's too good. We are here at the Conway Expo Center. Build My Future is the event, first ever of its kind. First, we mentioned a minute ago, we have Bill Rochelle, president of the Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. Bill, good to have you back. And we also have a friend of ours, Lisa Dover, who we've known, and her husband, Jeremy, have been friends forever, and you have a new venture going on now. No more television. You're doing well. You still do some television,
right?
But you have your own agency, PR, advertising, and such.
Yeah, we've got JF Media and marketing, and so yeah, I love helping local companies now get the word out about who they are and what they do.
So Justin just joined us, Bill, and so all of our listeners may have tuned in for the first time. So this is a unique event, Justin. 1,200 high school students are coming in, and most of these seniors. Is that what they are?
They'll be anywhere from 9th to 12th graders.
So they're coming in here, and you guys have how many booths set up? How many booths are here?
We've got 40 exhibitors here today.
Now, this is not a career fair, right, Justin. All the booths have hands-on things, for example, like that kids could actually be involved with.
Yeah, they can build Nabholz. We're going to be building benches at the Nabholz booth. We've got equipment demos outside. They're literally going to be able to ABC Block and Brick is here. They're going to be lay mortar, build a stack block and brick.
Stack block.
Yeah.
Jackhammer. You got welding.
Virtual welding. Yeah.
We had Channel 7, Emma Allen, building bricks today. Yeah. Slinging bricks.
So the theory.
Well, I saw one of the tables that was being built. I'd like that right now.
That's right. Listen.
I know you hear it. Yeah. All over the place.
Well, and again, the point is you don't have to follow a certain career path. You don't have to go to college. You know, you can have a career with you're working with your hands, or you can become a contractor.
Absolutely.
You know, I love the ambiance behind us now. Right. And that's basically who are here, the company's here today.
That's it. Yes, sir. For them to get, you know, the students to be able to get some hands-on experience. You know, we go to career fairs at school, and that's just more grabbing pamphlets or handing out pamphlets. Here, they're going to actually get to build stuff, get their hands dirty. I tell you, the cool thing is at 11:30, we're going to serve 1,400 Chick-fil-A sandwiches.
Well,
see how that goes.
Even bigger than that, Bill, so we got a special surprise that people don't know, Raj, that you're doing a special demonstration outside here, I think at 11:30. It has to do with fire.
It has to do with fire.
And apparently a special guest may be a part of that. That Wrestling Man is going to be making an appearance.
You're right, David. We ask if Wrestling Man could be here because they're literally this burn trailer. Half of it has a fire suppression system. The other half doesn't. So they'll light the one side and it'll get to a point and then the fire department will put it out. They light the other side and it's got a fire suppression system. So it gets to a point and then the system comes on and puts it out.
Well, I think of a burn trailer, I think of Wrestling Man.
I do too. I hope he's around here somewhere.
Wrestling Man?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Great to see you here. I remember Lisa Dover. It's great to see you again. See the sweetheart. I remember going out to Bryan High School. Some, I don't know how long it's been. She was there as well, a young little cheerleader. I knew she was one of them who's who. And now look at her. She's where.
Yeah, I know. Right,
Bill, you and I go way back as well. You and your sweet little daughter as well. We've all been fans. Let me tell you something. I don't kid around with fire.
Yeah, that's right.
Now, I use it a lot in all of some of my bits, but I take it seriously. Because fire can be your friend. It can be your enemy.
Yes, sir.
You need fire to cook.
Yes.
Fire kills. Made me quite a bit of money there. Quite a bit of money there, Jay. But hey, listen, how come you blocked me?
What a, so WrestleMan, are you actually going to be involved with this today? Or you
I'm just setting it ablaze.
You see, you're setting it ablaze.
Absolutely, I am. Because you want to make sure that you do it. Listen. I've got some retardant clothes on.
So this is not open to the public, by the way. You can't just show up here. We want to make sure nobody decides to come up and try to get their kid here today. You'd have to
pre-register.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. And so, and this is the first year you've done this in Arkansas, right?
First one we've done it here in Central Arkansas. The last 3 years we've done one up in Northwest Arkansas, and so we kind of spent 3 years, you know, learning exactly what we needed to do, and so. We took the leap of faith this year and doing one here in Central Arkansas.
I think it's cool.
Alicia, I know that this is something you've already had Channel 7 out here doing some work, right?
Yeah. And you know what's really cool, too, is there's some virtual reality stuff that I was walking around just looking at all the booths. Kids can put on these VR headsets and learn how to weld.
Yes.
Without actually.
Well,
you've got to have a good bead.
Yeah, Justin, we were talking about people don't realize, and I know people in that industry who are welders that make darn good money.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, and you know, they may be in a particular part of the country.
Or a different part of the world.
Yeah. And Bill, I mean, it's, you know, there's
you
one guy.
About my cousin.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
What he does.
That's right. And there's a social media influencer.
I know, right?
There's a social media influencer that's a high end welder and that does really. And he said, "Man, I make $250,000 a year because I've called in to do special kind of welding." Anyway, there's just a lot of that people don't know about, and this is the opportunity for kids to know. You know what? You know where I first learned my lesson about this kind of thing? It's about my first rent house, Justin and Raj, and I didn't know what to do on all the plumbing, electrical,
right.
And I started realizing that when I call on somebody. Back then, this was back in the 80s, it was going to cost me $50 an hour. Yeah. This is in the 80s, and there was going to be more than one worker. And by the time he was done, it was going to be a $300, $400 charge. Yeah. And I realized, you know what? There's a guy who owns this company. He's got about 10 of these guys out here today making this. And so, you know, I don't know if people realize the economics of that and the job security if you have these kind of skills.
Trades, trades like that, that you do really well. I read an article, this was, I don't know, years ago now. Because my generation, everybody said, and I don't know if Alicia, you and I are mm-hmm. near the same age.
We are.
I'm probably a little bit older, but that said, you know, our generation, they said, if you don't go to college, you're a failure.
That's it.
You know, you got to go be a nurse. You got to go be this. You got to go do this. And there were too many overqualified people to go into the job pool. And it was about, hey, we need more people who are skilled in trade.
Yeah.
Yeah.
People,
and
like
that
you said, plumbers, electricians, the welders, I mean, it goes on and on and on. And you don't have to spend 4, 5, 6 years in college. And you make more money.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And
those
student loans, you know, people are racking up student loans. A lot of these high school students are realizing, hey, I can come right out of high school and start my career, become an entrepreneur and fill a need of skilled labor.
Well, there's always been a need for the folks here.
Yeah.
Whether it be electricians, especially welders and all of that. It's even more so now. I forget what the number is I heard the other day, but the workforce and Americans have gotten lazy. We give too much away that with some of the immigration that's coming in. I mean, they are filling jobs that we just won't do. And when it comes to those plumbers and all that, and the electricians, and more power to them, it may be $50 an hour, 2 hour minimum.
That's what I'm saying. You earned it.
You bet. Listen, if you can go in there and do that, it'll take me all day. I can't tell you how much time I spent one time going back at our old house and replacing. If you don't use the right stuff, it's crazy.
replacing the water hose to a refrigerator for the ice maker. Been about a dozen years. I spent hundreds of dollars.
Instead of calling the man?
Instead of calling the man. I wanted to save money on the pipe tape. I had to use pipe tape. I thought I was a guy.
I will say this, and I know he's listening, the guy who built my house, Keith Hart, who listens to this, listens to this on a regular basis. When I was getting my house redone, I was fascinated going and watching every part of that process. These guys would come in and they would tear something down, rebuild it. Because they basically gutted my house. So I saw this whole thing, didn't plan on that happening, but that's what ended up happening. But I thought it was fascinating to see the skill and these guys did with their hands get out and listen, they were doing math equations. And I was like, do you measure this? And like, dude, I could do that in school probably anyway. So I think it's, until you maybe sometimes get a chance to see that in person, you don't realize just how impressive it is, that skill.
Oh, no doubt.
Yeah, the craftsmanship of some of our members is just unbelievable. When you see some of the carpentry skills that they have, it's just unbelievable. But to touch on what Alicia said, I mean, a lot of these guys, they started out with a dream, a truck, a ladder, willing to take a chance, and they got out there and they borrowed money to get started. Now you see a lot of their banners hanging out here with their names on them.
Well, we appreciate you having us out here. I can't wait to see Justin, the doors open. What time the kids get here? 8 o'clock?
Kids get here at 8:30.
Yeah. 1200 kids are going to just be piling in here at once, and it's going to be sort of madness, but I can't wait to hear the noises behind us in terms of what all the kids are doing. I do want to give a big thank you to Greg Hatcher, who has really been instrumental in what we're doing today down in Dallas. We're going to the Star, these young guys who are the Cliff Harris Award winners, I let them know. I said, listen, guys, I said, you're getting ready to go to the most valued sports franchise headquarters in the world. And it's so funny, I just need to give you this is a small college defensive player of the year, and the smallest one is NAIA, which it's a low-level sport. You don't have, from a financial standpoint, you don't have all the millions, and you're not getting paid anything. So our winner this year said, man, I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it. I said, well, man, we're flying them in, putting them up at the hotel overlooking the Dallas football practice field.
Wow.
He said, I don't know if I'm going to be, because he just graduated, because he said, man, he said, I just started my job. I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm working at the prison. I said, you're working at the prison? He said, yeah, I'm too low on the totem pole to move up. I said, young man, I'm going to say, I said, you're getting ready to meet an NFL Hall of Famer. You're getting ready to meet the executive vice president of the Cowboys. And I said, this is sort of a really cool deal. You're getting ready to see your $3,000 trophy. And I said, if I got to call your boss,
Warden,
I said, we're going to get you here. And so he is here, flew in with his mother.
That's outstanding.
What's that?
You finished. Go ahead.
No, I'm just saying. And so all three of the winners, he's here with either his mother or his father.
That's right.
They're sharing the room together overlooking that, and their coach is flying in. And so anyway, I just love that kind of story that it reminds you that it's not about the NIL for everybody. Here's a kid who just got out of school. He's working at the prison and thinks he can't even get off to come get his award. When we turn on the TV and these guys are making $500,000 and $800,000. I just think that's sort of the beauty of small college sports. So anyway, thanks to Greg Hatcher and Wright Lindsay and Jennings and Simmons and all the Touchdown Club, because that I think these are the kind of deals. They're so excited today.
Doing what you do.
I'm a facilitator.
Shut up and let me tell you.
That's what's cool about the Cliff Harris Award. I mean, and honestly, I've never really thought about that before. All these colleges that they don't get any recognition at all most of the time.
That's right. Yeah.
And this cat working at the prison, that's not an easy gig.
No, that's his first job out of college.
Listen, it's a tough gig psychologically with what you have to put up with. They pay well.
Listen, I love the fact he said, man, I'm the low in the totem pole. Justin, you were saying something. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was just saying, I respect that about you.
You sure? Exactly. You're dang straight. I love it.
Go to work.
Dang
this
straight.
Generation don't normally do that.
No, so. That's what I was saying earlier.
Go to work.
He's got a job.
That's right.
I tell you, another guy that's got a job out there, our buddy Brian Duke just reminded me, he and his family own 3-Star Muffler.
Yeah.
I think it's the oldest muffler shop in the state of Arkansas. He's a welder.
Yeah,
that's what they do there at the muffler shop. And you got to do that perfectly as well. So he'll be looking for employees as well.
It takes all of us to make the world go round, right?
Absolutely.
We got a guy on this show who's got 12 number one hits, plays in front of thousands
on
the weekend.
Right there.
We got another guy right here who can make noises like a velociraptor or a T-Rex. And can also do Frank Sinatra or Dean Martin at the drop of a hat.
You got that right, baby.
Well, Bill, thanks for having us here.
Yes, sir.
We'll get you on a little bit later, and We'll be ready for the wave of kids coming in here. And Alicia, it's always great to see you. Yeah. Jeremy, we were hoping Jeremy was going to be on this trip to Dallas, but he's got some other things coming up. So, but you two are the dynamic couple.
Well, yeah. You know, the buzz is why we're together.
Is that right?
Yeah. We would not be married if it wasn't for the buzz. We met at a buzz event.
How about that?
Yeah.
On Halloween,
we were dressed up. You and Jeremy.
Oh, my gosh. The Halloween
deal? Were we the three amigos?
You were dressed up as the three amigos.
Oh, my gosh. I remember that.
Matt.
Double R, does this make you proud to hear that?
It is wonderful for me to see little Ed and Jay Fly getting together. I performed the wedding.
We
have a buzz marriage and buzz babies.
Jeremy and I are text buddies.
Oh, is that right? Yeah. Well, I'll never forget that. I'll never forget Jeremy and Justin. This Justin played Bill in front of there was the first time ever in the history of Simmons Bank Arena. You played in front of nobody because of COVID, and he did a live concert. Remember?
Oh, wow, I bet it was.
Crazy.
All right.
But let's be honest. That's not that big a deal. I could go to Alta or Simmons right now and play in front of nobody.
Harder than you think. All right. 7:45 here, Morning Mayhem.
Nobody would show up.
Spring calls for fresh style, and you can find it at Sissy's Log Cabin. Their selection truly has everything for anyone at a range of price points. Shop the latest trends from designers like David Yurman, Lagos, and Roberto Coin. Browse timepieces from brands like Luminox, Tudor, or Tag Heuer. Find the perfect diamond. Discover amazing estate pieces you won't find anywhere else. Whatever you're looking for, I guarantee you can find it at Sissy's. To match their incredible selection, they also have the best service. They always treat me like family. No one is more friendly, attentive, and invested in making sure you get exactly what you want. They'll even make a custom creation for you if you don't find exactly what you're looking for in their expansive collection. Really, the whole experience is best summed up by the Sissy's promise of unmatched quality and service. Ready to experience Sissy's for yourself? Shop online at sissyslogcabin.com or visit any of their 6 locations in Pine Bluff, Little Rock Heights, Little Rock Promenade, Jonesboro, Memphis, or Conway.
Roger Scott here. You guys know how much I love the great outdoors. I mean, I am the naked gardener after all, and there's nothing that I love more than my very own lawn and being outside. But let's be honest, when the mosquitoes attack, it can be a real buzzkill. However, a monthly mosquito barrier from my friends at Sanders Ground Essentials can keep those skeeters away, which keeps my deck party going. Call them today at 315-9395 or on the web at sandersground.com. Sanders Ground Essentials. Let's get growing.
Let me tell you about my friends, Carl and Karen. This place is sus. Let's go to Tunica.
And so they did. And immediately, they became winners.
Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning. Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning.
And not just gaming either. They did spinning, dancing, or enjoying a world-renowned meal.
Winning.
No matter what you're doing in Tunica, you're always a winner. Learn more at tunicatravel.com.
Hello, Buzz listeners. It's Chris Zender, and I've got some big news. Fletcher Dodge has big discounts on all new Rams, up to $11,000 off new Ram 2500s and up to $10,000 off new half-ton Rams. But that's not all. We got 0% financing on new Ram Bighorns for 72 months. Yes. I said 0% for 72 months. Or how about $10,000 off new Jeep Gladiators? And we have the new 2024 Jeep Compass four-wheel drives for only $424 a month with zero down and no gimmicks. We're getting new inventory every week, so come in and let us know what you're looking for. We're ready to make a deal. We have pre-owned vehicles starting as low as $199 a month at zero down. Don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us or apply from anywhere at FletcherCredit.com. Fast, easy, and simple approval process. And let us help you get into a new or pre-owned vehicle. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now. I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GEAR for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code GEAR for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code GEAR.
Roger Scott here. Let me remind you about my friends at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union. They have some of the most aggressive auto loan rates for Buzz listeners in Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. Easy access to Alcoa's team of loan officers online, by phone or in person at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union's two locations in Benton and Sheridan, and apply online at alcoacommunityfcu.org.
Can you hear Justin Moore's smoke alarm every 10 minutes? If you can, text our Southern Structural Solutions text line at 501-661-1037.
There's a place in Little Rock right next to the station that you're
right there
right now.
Is your family listening?
Fresh seafood in daily.
I'm sure it's great.
It is great. You don't have to be a smart ass. I'm trying to take your side.
You can't even be on his side.
Like, I'm trying to take your side here, but it is great. It's called Brave News.
I think it's too, it's Josh's delivery is what makes it too.
But it is.
Smart ass.
That is just.
Hello, it's Roger and David. Go ahead.
Huh? Mark the tape.
Terrible. Terrible. That is so good. And somebody just texted me and said, Roger, are you playing at Simmons? No. If I were to be at Simmons, no one would be in there. That's my point. I wouldn't be in, let alone sing. And I got to point something else out. David Hendricks texted me yesterday. He and his wife, Dana, whom I love, were listening. And then my wife was the same way. She said they heard what they thought might have been me cussing yesterday.
What was it?
I don't know. Was it about Bunton, maybe? When it's
oh my God, you did, Justin. No, remember what he said?
Why don't you just,
oh my God!
Why don't you?
It's almost Josh asked.
Why don't you let me finish blaming people? I didn't do it. That's the deal.
You did.
Obviously, it was Josh doing a gross overdub or AI Roger. About that. So to Samantha as well, she said you better straighten that out.
And yeah, Justin,
it wasn't me. I apologize for that. She said, you know what? Not only are other people's grandkids listening,
yeah,
yours are.
You almost went, we blacked out because, Josh has dropped the T and D word, and then you dropped the B word yesterday.
No. Justin, please, but you heard it in Justin right there. And I didn't do it. It was obviously a gross overdub, but I apologize for anybody that heard that, and I will not do it again.
Somebody says here on the text line, have you guys discussed the news that Jerry Jones offering double what Kentucky players are making at Kentucky? I had heard through the grapevine that the NIL deal, all the $5 million or whatever, that's not even done yet. They have not got the commitments for that. So I have no idea if that's true or not. But I thought that was interesting, Justin and Raj, that I think we hear all these things and we don't have confirmations of it. And of course, we didn't know Warren Stevens was involved besides Johnny Tyson. And then to find out.
Guys, we still don't know. We don't know.
All the,
how much a kid's making. We don't know.
Or how much money we have and how much money we got to raise. So here's what I love this. My 18-year-old.
Here's how much money we need to raise. More.
Yes.
I mean, that's reality.
That's right.
Nowadays, these kids have agents.
I know.
And so, you know, if you take a visit to, there's a kid from, I think he played for Kentucky last year. No. Excuse me. It's one of the 5-star kids that allegedly we're recruiting that had committed to Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
Right. He's taking a visit to Louisville. So now, this is what's going on now, again, allegedly, is he going to Louisville bargaining, so that we have to pay him more to get him here?
Right.
I know. It's like a head coaching search now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Names come out.
That's it.
Or, just so they get a raise at their place. Now, I'm going to take this visit. So instead of getting $500,000, I'm
right.
Gonna get 600,000.
Yeah, I know. Isn't it crazy?
It's just absolutely.
And then on the other hand, I'm reading one of our text line here. It says, my 18-year-old daughter drives an off-road dump truck making $60,000 a year, no student loans. Nice. you know, again, yeah, again, puts things in perspective, you know, compared to. And the other thing I think is interesting, you know, KJ Jefferson, I'm sure UCF Central Florida fans love to see that his mugshot yesterday, although it was basically something he had done last year. Did you see how fast he was going, Justin, on 49?
Interstate 40.
It was going 113 in his Dodge Challenger. And so once you go 50 miles over the speed limit, you're charged with reckless driving. And so I guess he had to come back.
How do you afford that Challenger?
I wonder.
He has two vehicles, right?
I think he had two last year. But you know, of course, you know, he said, hey, man, all it was a speeding ticket. But anyway, just this day and age where you're paying that big money.
No, that's not just a speeding ticket.
That's right. Okay. That's what he said. That's right. Yes.
I mean, that's what stopped it. What happened to our player that wasn't able to make it? Wasn't he speeding through the tunnel last year?
Oh yeah, the young man who had a wreck. I don't know if he was speeding, but there was a wreck on the post on the backside of it. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what I think of. I mean, the danger involved.
Yeah.
In doing that, when you're going down 49, it's at night. Those cables that are dividing your side of the highway to the other one, not going to stop a car doing a 120. If it crosses over, but don't get me wrong.
Listen,
he's a 20-year-old
that's
kid.
Right. Yeah,
I'm not making excuses.
Yeah, right.
But even 50-year-olds, and we've talked about it. We've gone that.
Well, we've done stupid things
hopefully
like that too.
He won't do it again. Nobody was hurt. He won't do it again.
Almost $1 million.
Too. Yeah. Yeah.
What's that?
Boy, that's another issue that nobody wants to talk about.
Yeah.
With this NIL stuff.
Yeah.
Is these kids have not been prepared, taught, educated
to deal with that kind of money. Yeah,
sure.
Yeah. By the way, I went back and watched.
It's money wasted, in my opinion. I don't mean to interrupt.
Yes, sir.
Baz, but like when they go into the pros, they educate them on. Now,
try to
they take
yeah.
the advice, or they don't. But are we doing that in college? I doubt it.
Doubt it. Well, I watched the spring game again last night on TV. I like the trade at quarterback. All right, 8 o'clock.
Whoa, Howie, that's a lot of diamonds. What's going on?
We're about to launch the biggest natural loose diamond event we've had in the history of Robert Irwin Jewelers.
Any shape, any size?
Yes, natural loose diamonds for any budget. Plus, get a free men's wedding band with every natural loose diamond purchase. 0% interest for up to 5 years. See a store for complete details.
It's the biggest natural loose diamond and bridal event this weekend at the West Little Rock location in the Pleasant Ridge Town Center.
Robert Irwin Jewelers, home of the meant-to-be guarantee, upgrades are welcome.
Hello, Arkansas, Montana with Hubbard Power Sports in Russellville. We are your passionately motivated Can-Am and Sea-Doo dealer. Whether you are on the road, on the water, or in the trails, we've got the ride for you. Our Can-Am and Sea-Doo dealership in Russellville offers a large variety of units in stock now. We are a family-owned and operated crew and celebrating 24 years in business this summer. See our current inventory, apply for financing, and value your trade at our website, HubbardPowerSports.com. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram. Stop by and see us Monday through Saturday for the best customer service around. We hope to see you soon.
Tickets are on sale now for the 20th annual Double B's Buzzbecue Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Go to buzzbecue.com.
Do you smell that? That's the smell of men being men.
I think I'm ready.
On 103.7 The Buzz, KABC Little Rock.
Buzz News with KARK's Claire Kreitz.
Four men were arrested for a shooting that killed one person and hurt nine others in Wynn. Quavarius Millen, Carl Washington, Cameron Crawford, and Tommy Frost are facing several charges, including first-degree murder. Arkansas legislators are working to amend the state's current crypto mining law. Two of the eight resolutions presented on the House floor passed yesterday. The current law allows local governments to have control over crypto mining sites and put a stop to them. The resolutions passed aim to expand that, giving the city and county governments control over the sites once they're built. An Arkansas woman received a national award for her work following the tornado that hit Wynn last year. Leanne Lovell founded the Wynn Relief and Recovery Organization. She established a distribution center, brought in doctors and counselors, and secured temporary housing. This is Claire Kreitz for the Buzz Radio Network.
Anywhere in the state, dial 888-888-8888 for Rainwater Holton Sexton. They'll help you weather the storm.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz Weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too, a high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special, dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, two sides, and our famous salad bar, only $60. Good Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Want the latest information on bass tournaments and the best fishing spots in the state? Then listen to Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings with Big Sarge and his crew. Fishing Arkansas is presented by Shelter Insurance Agent Jamie Marsh, Stanley Hardware, Fletcher Auto Group, Axles Plus, and Cooper's Nursery in Cabot. Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings on 103.7 The Buzz.
Hey, it's David Basil from my good friends, the Lawsons at Luxury Pool & Spa in Conway and Russellville. Going on this week, now through Saturday, at both stores is the annual Luxury Pool & Spa sale. It's a big tradition, and it only lasts 1 week during the year. You can save 20% off store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, in stock or special order. Luxury Pool & Spas also have huge rebates this week on Pool Life and Bakwasil Pool Chemicals. Their amazing spas, like the one I have at my house, are also discounted at prices lower than even their truckload sale. Luxury Pool & Spa will have daily giveaways, including PK grills and $150 Luxury Pool & Spa gift card. They'll also give away a Pentair pool cleaner, variable speed pump, salt system, and a Ledge Lounger Lays pillow. Over $12,000 in giveaways during this big 20% off store-wide sale going on now through this Saturday at Luxury Pool & Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com. Live the life of luxury with Luxury Pool & Spa. Get by and see them this week and tell them Morning Mayhem sent you.
The Can-Am sales event continues at all Bradford Marine and ATV locations. ATVs like the Defender Max XMR offered as low as 1.99% APR or up to 5.99% for 72 months. For ATV safety and training information, call the ATV Safety Institute.
Hi, I'm Hunter Bell from Bell Chevrolet, and I want to tell you the real reason it's better at Bell. Our people, our family, and our community that drives us to be the best. We're proud to offer our biggest inventory and lowest prices on every single vehicle, from the all-new Silverado to the all-electric Chevy Equinox. We're going to find you the perfect vehicle with a buying experience like nowhere else. Our commitment is to you every day. Shop Bell Chevrolet and BellChevrolet.com today. Together, let's drive.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn, with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Craig O'Neill here, known for TV and radio in Arkansas, but if I was a superstar college athlete, I'd make sure my name, image, and likeness were associated with a winning team, like Genesis of Conway, the newest luxury automotive dealer in Central Arkansas. Their trophy case is out there on their lot with award-winning sedans and SUVs and electrics if you want them, and a service team that'll make you feel like a champion. I know if I was doing ads, that's who I'd do them for. Go see them or go to genesisofconway.com, the future of luxury today.
I'm here with Laura Beth from Kaufman by Design West. Kaufman has over 7,000 square feet of beautiful new home decor pieces and design specialists on staff. See, that would be important for somebody like me who is design challenged.
Yeah, we have design specialists on staff and everything you need, from lighting to flooring, designer hardware, and more.
And gift cards are available too. Check them out now. Kaufman by Design West, out west past Taylor Loop, 14900 Cantrell Road.
Or visit us online at kaufmanlumber.com.
Right now at Fort Thompson, Smith & Wesson Shield, 2.09 millimeter, $269.90. Beretta APX-A1, 9 millimeter, $199.90 after $50 mail-in rebate. CCI 9 millimeter brass, 50 count box, $12.99 at Fort Thompson and Sherwood.
Do you recycle? Sure you do. Or you'd like to. Recycling is easy because you don't have to separate recyclable material. We'll do that for you. Just throw it in the cart. Loose. No bagging. To do recycling right, you need to know what should go in your cart and what shouldn't. To learn more, go to mydoright.com. At mydoright.com, we'll show you how to do recycling right. Do right and do it the right way.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
Defense, on you.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
I don't want them to gain another yard.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
You blitz all night.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, it is it's 8:06 here on Morning Mayhem. We're going in deer stand. We're going in deer stand mode because we're standing next to the ribbon cutting of this event for Build My Future at the Conway Expo Center. If you can't, Roger, you got the camera on them. You see a lot of the construction contractor folks that are here today. There are about 50 different businesses here that will be hosting 1,200 kids here in about 30 minutes.
No, that's okay.
I think I need to hear Justin's that's my boy. Oh, there we go. Now get ready to cut the ribbon. But we do appreciate you being part of this day today. Yesterday we were at Luxury Pool and Spa. They're having their big sale all the way to the end of the week. Thanks to them for having us out there. Tomorrow we'll be at Kaufman by Design in West Little Rock. Mm-hmm. Justin, where do you play this weekend? Do you know?
I don't. How about that? I don't.
Yeah, that's
well, you don't play, or you don't know where you're playing.
No, I don't play.
Hey, before we go to Tommy Smith, I wanted to ask Justin. Tonight you got Skinnerd and ZZ Top, and I'm going to try to go to that after I get back from Dallas, and we have the Hall of Fame reception. But somebody made the point there are zero members of Skinnerd remaining from their classic lineup. And they said Gary Rossington died. I guess it was last year. Is that correct? There's nobody in the band from original.
The only one that's somewhat original, their lead guitar player now, was one of their original drummers when they first started.
Gotcha. I wonder who it is.
Most people would not know that.
Yeah, I wonder. Wonder who's playing. You're going to see Lynyrd Skynyrd. This one of them is Lynyrd Skynyrd.
And you still have Johnny Van Zandt, which is Ronnie's brother.
Mm-hmm.
He was a member of 38 Special.
Gotcha. Yeah.
You know. So hold on loosely.
A great song. Yeah.
Don't let it go. He's still the lead singer, and he sounds a lot like Ronnie, but nobody's Ronnie.
Yeah.
But no, that's why when I had the opportunity to go on tour with him, back in, was it 08 or 09?
Yeah, 08, wow.
It was one of the two. When I had the opportunity to go out with him, they still had Billy Powell, the piano player, Ian, the bass player, Gary Rossington, the guitar player who played the slide stuff and like on all those old iconic
slide
parts.
That's cool that you were able to be there with all those guys.
You had the guy that I just mentioned. There was a lot of original members, you know, at that there was four or five at least, mm-hmm. you know, at that point in time. So, and then Ian, the bass player, died of cancer. Then Billy died. Billy Powell. I still look back on that and go, man,
oh my, yes, no question. Me, you know? No question. Speaking of a guy who played a lot of Lynyrd Skynyrd, let's check in with Tommy Smith there, Josh.
All aboard. That's right. He's back. The outlaw, Tommy Smith, legendary Arkansas radio voice from the Rock and Roll Breakfast on Magic 105 and two decades on the Buzz's Show with No Name. He's back with the boys on Morning Mayhem.
Tommy Smith on Morning Mayhem is brought to you by Hubbard Power Sports, Can-Am, and Sea-Doo in Russellville. Whether you're on the road, in the water, or in the trails, we've got a ride for you.
Good morning, Tommy.
Hey, how are you?
We're doing good, buddy. How many of those names that did you recall when Justin, if you heard Justin talking about Lynyrd Skynyrd, do you know all those?
Quite a few of them, yeah.
How many Lynyrd
Skynyrd? Yeah. Back in the day when I had a long pro.
Yeah, how many?
Not long ago.
How many do you recall having Leonard Skinner in your studio, Tommy? Any of the members in the studio?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. They were animals. They were. We had the studios up on the hill in Conway, and there was a snake one day, and Sammy Hagar would back the limo up so he could see a snake, and then ran over. They were just unbelievably.
Did you have some Skinnerd with go, you? But, had some Skinnerd in your studio?
What?
Did you say you had some Skinnerd?
Do you have Leonard Skinnerd ever, any of the guys from Leonard Skinnerd in the studio with you?
Not after the passing, no.
What about ZZ Top?
Best. They were the best. I don't know how they did that without that beard, but they carried it well.
Yeah, I think Mike.
I've been working a while. I kind of got a ZZ Top beard going myself.
Yeah, they could have between 7,000 and 8,000 there.
That's
tonight.
Great.
Yeah, that, and
those
not are bad.
Two,
yeah.
Those could stand alone. You want to go see either one of them by themselves.
Yeah. Tommy, last night, obviously Razorbacks win the last two games. Have you been following the baseball at all?
I'm sorry, you broke up.
I said, have you been following the Razorback baseball team much? Obviously, they win the last two games against Texas Tech at home.
Boy, a couple of thrills, I tell you that right now. I actually listened to a baseball game last night.
Yeah, Phil does.
And,
yeah.
You know, your ups or downs, your highs or lows. And I think you're going to bounce back and be just fine, just fine. He knows what he's doing.
Yeah,
our new coach of basketball. What do y'all think about that?
Oh, we're very happy about that. Obviously, the sign the first player. We were talking about with Joe Klein too. We really haven't had many 7-footers, Tommy, in the history of the program that have been dominant players. Now we've had plenty of guys that were 6'10", 6'11", like Joe, but very rare 7-footers that are as talented as this guy is from Croatia. So. And plus, he's got.
I thought it was that guy, Stephen Hill.
What was he, Roger? He said he was 7'2".
Yeah,
he was a 7-footer.
Yeah,
maybe. 7'2".
He was probably.
I don't know if he was that tall, but he wasn't a really skilled player.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, he could block it. He had one season where he kind of stepped up, and I think it was maybe the defensive player of the year in the SEC or something like that. It was more of a defensive kind of rim protector.
Yeah.
I'm telling you guys right now, this guy didn't play a ton at Kentucky last year, but there were a lot of reasons why, outside of talent and basketball, you know, him getting cleared and being from a different country. But what I watched his highlights.
Yeah.
This kid's got a chance to be a long-time pro.
That's what Joe said. That's what Joe Klein said.
In the NBA, not
right.
In the European League.
Right.
I mean, he's that skilled. I mean, his shot looks like Pat Bradley.
Yeah.
The three-point line, and he's 7'2". I mean,
shot me a couple of questions last night before.
I cannot.
I found very. Very intriguing to him.
I think it was today is National Lineman Day. Weird, Roger, that we're and Justin, we're here at a place where we're teaching people to do things with their hands. But it's National Lineman Day, which is Lineman of the County. I think of that with Glenn Campbell, and the other is obviously you can also go offensive or defensive lineman. So of course, I question when you, Roger, if I were to ask you and Tommy, who was the greatest lineman to ever play at Arkansas? What would you say?
I will say Jerry Jones.
Oh, you could say that. He was an offensive lineman.
See what I did there?
You did.
You see what I did?
Yeah, what about you, Tommy? Who do you think the greatest offensive lineman
ever? I'm going to say Steve Court.
Steve Court was who I played with, the strongest man in college football, almost bench pressed 600 pounds. Justin, what about you?
How long ago was that?
Great. That was in 1982.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah, it was. 1982. Yeah, go ahead.
Because of his pro career, I'll go Sean Andrews.
Sean Andrews, maybe the most decorated. I think he was 2-time All-American.
Yeah.
And played every game. I think he started as a freshman. And you can make the argument.
He played in the NFL for what? 20 years.
He did something crazy. He did, but you want to hear something crazy?
Yes.
Do you know that Jason Peters, who will go in the Arkansas Sports Hall of Fame this Friday night, he's not going to be there, but he is still playing in the NFL, and my understanding is he's the oldest player to ever play in the offensive line in the history of the NFL. This is his 20th year.
What an athlete.
And
didn't he play O-line in college?
No, he's a tight end.
Or vice versa, tight end in college and O-line and the pros?
Yeah, he was a heck of an athlete. And
that may be who I'm thinking about, actually.
Sean Andrews was a great.
He was a beast. He didn't play in a bowl game.
Yeah, he was.
He was the first guy that I remember saying, "No, I'm not playing. I'm that good." But when you look at it, the other part of that I look at, and knowing Peters, and what he did coming out of either Atlanta or Queen City, Texas, might have been one of those because I know he was same age as my oldest son. Is the NFL coaches who said, "We're going to put you here."
Yeah.
And look at that.
They knew how good of an athlete he was.
I like that as well.
He may be, guys. I've said this before, Tommy, back when we were doing the show. And Justin, I played with Steve Atwater. And I think Steve Atwater is probably one of the greatest athletes that I ever played with. Of course, I played against Bo, but I'm talking about on my team. But Jason Peters, I'll never forget going out to practice and watching them run sprints. And I remember telling one of the assistant coaches, I says, "Who is the big dude over there running with the running backs and quarterback?" Mm-hmm. And they go, "That's a kid named Jason Peters." And he was like 6'3", 6'4", 260, and he is long striding. And I said, I've never seen a guy that big run like that. Of course, you know, Houston didn't throw to him a whole lot, a little bit. He scored, he plays in the double over, seven overtime. Right. But, man, they need great tackles in the NFL, and that's why he was so athletic. That's why they wanted to score and move him out there. But he's had a Hall of Fame career.
Do you remember his first catch? As a tight end,
was it in the seven overtime?
Auburn.
Okay, no,
down the right sideline, kind of mom. Remember you going? The guy's like 6'6". Well, what? Boy, he was good though.
Yeah,
golly, he was good.
I think you're right.
He's a runner's country squad up by radio.
Did you, Tommy? Did you get a chance to watch any of the red and white game?
No.
I made the comment going to break.
I hear that this quarterback, and Frank Fletcher told me this about 3 months ago. He says this quarterback was that. What is the name? Green?
Green is correct, yes.
Yeah. They say he's the real deal.
Yeah, I made the comment. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, I was just saying I made the comment going to break. I don't know if you caught it, but I like the trade that we did between KJ and if we get Taylen Green and KJ goes to Central Florida, I like it because I'm telling you, y'all, this, I went back and again, watched the spring practice on film after being there, in person.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, he is a challenge to stop. He's got a great arm, got great accuracy, and he can fly. He's a lot like Matt Jones and he covers a lot of ground, but yeah, there's no question. He's a difference maker. If the offensive line will come along with him.
Well, about halfway through the season, people are going to be going, KJ who?
Yeah, I think so. And I think, obviously Petrino, the offense is going to be.
All these records out there right now will not be broken because they're not going to be there that long. So old timers was those crazy records. They're safe. Nobody's going to touch them.
That is a true point. Doesn't KJ, you're right. Probably nobody will ever, because KJ played as a freshman.
No. Right?
KJ played as a freshman, so nobody's going to be able to probably.
Oh, and that's something else that I saw.
He started one game.
Oh, yeah, one game. That's right. Yeah,
Correct me.
But they played three years as a starter, which you don't always get.
Yeah. Who are the other guys? When I was reading the police log on KJ, he's one of three cats to be a three-time team captain. Who are the other two?
Well, back in the old days, you were a team captain 1 year, your senior year, and so they've. I don't know when they started changing that. So that's a good question. Yeah, when I were around, you had to be a senior for the most part.
Yeah, I'm trying to think, and the other part about that is when I see all the records that he broke here, it just sort of sucks for the fact that he's not finishing his career here.
KJ?
Yeah.
I know.
Because you look at him and you go.
You would think the guy who has records. All the records, you would want to finish it here. I know.
Well, that's a good point, Ross.
Yeah.
Let's think back to, let's say even, I was going to say 10 years ago, but you could even go like 5-6 years ago.
Yeah, you could.
And you said, hey, the quarterback who has
holds
basically
yes.
every single record at the University of Arkansas, his senior year, he started for 3 years prior.
Mm-hmm.
His senior year,
right.
he's going to transfer to Central Florida.
Right. No.
You'd go,
yeah.
huh?
Yeah.
What? What? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, puff, puff, it's, pass. Puff, puff, pass.
That's the world we live in.
It is. Now.
It is. Of course, and I always, and I look at it as well. I don't look at it as, and I probably shouldn't think this way, as successful like I do with Tony Romo, you know, who set all those records with the Cowboys, but he's got, you know, no championships, let alone.
It is. This is the day and age that we live in, which I don't. Yeah.
Look at our buddy Battle.
I know. The all time leading quarterback statistic is not even
finishing at UCF, as Justin just said.
Do want to thank Hubbard Power Sports, Can Am, and CDU and Russellville for sponsoring Tommy each week, and we appreciate them.
They got it all, man. We got CDU. They got it all. If you want to travel by land. And the water, whatever, they got Sea-Doos. I'm very interested in that right now.
Tommy, before we let you go, you want to hear something crazy? And I don't know if, Roger, you paid attention to this or not.
I do want to hear something crazy.
So this year, 2024, I don't think many people have talked about this. It is the 60th anniversary of the national championship that we won, our only national championship. It has been 60 years since we
football.
Won the, in football.
Yeah.
And, you know, you still have Jerry Jones, Jimmy Johnson, Freddie Marshall, all those guys, but it is
Switzer on the staff.
Switzer, that's right. Switzer's still there. Switzer was on the staff. That's a good point. But 60 years since we've won a national championship in football. I know. It's
Kenny Hatfield.
Kenny Hatfield. Yeah.
Absolutely amazing.
60 years.
I need to say hi to Roger. Hey, Roger.
Hey, wait, say outlaw.
The other thing,
all of you, baby.
The other thing, Tommy, I've had some people.
Josh,
go ahead.
Tommy, yes, I'm here.
If you didn't have Josh, y'all would be lost.
I know.
Because that is one of the toughest jobs there is after being up there and seeing what goes on in that room. So, Josh, thank you.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you, Tommy.
Thank you, Josh. Josh.
Very kind of you.
We don't appreciate Josh as much as we should. When he's gone, we will. I'm not saying anything.
So, Tommy, one other thing before we let you go.
I'm kidding.
So everybody's telling me we need to get out. What's the place in Cabot that's got the strawberries? Holland Bottoms?
Holla at you.
Do they still have the strawberries out there?
Yes. And David, they got so popular, they had to build a new building. And I swear to you, people are lined up in their car and have to park it. And go up and wait in line for about 45 minutes to get strawberries.
Why is it? Why is it that place is the place? Is there no place in Poland that we can do strawberries?
Got to be in the manure. Got to be in the manure.
Unfortunately,
no.
I know. It just, I mean, you
What's
think.
What's up, Justin?
Yeah, say hello to Justin. You didn't say anything to
How
him.
How are you, sir?
Yeah,
great. I have not heard the weather forecast. What's it supposed to do today?
I think it's supposed to be nice.
Yeah,
a little warm.
Might be some storming up in northwest Arkansas, but don't hold me to it.
Well, listen, I want somebody to rival Holland Bottoms. I hear they like, DJ. Yes, it's, why is that the only place that has strawberries?
Well, I think they're the only one that does the strawberries or the melons or the pumpkins. I mean, that we know them well. I don't know where else anybody else is.
I mean,
City the only place that has daffodils?
They are the everybody that is the best strawberries.
Yes.
Why is it that they're?
I thought they had really good ones in Cabot, Tommy.
That's it.
That's where it is,
Justin.
That's
it's in Cabot. Yeah.
Did y'all see the women's ratings for the draft were the highest ever by like 350%?
No, the better
girl. And I think it's amazing. I probably watched as much girls basketball as I did guys.
No, the better stay.
Just fun to watch. fun to watch. I tell you, those girls, they never miss a free throw.
Yes, listen, the best stat on that on the draft deal, it had more viewership, I want to say this is right, than any game in the history of the WNBA. That draft had more viewership than any game ever that's been played in the WNBA, and maybe some other games too. So, Tommy, all right, buddy, have a great day, man. Appreciate you jumping on with us.
All right, Justin, Roger, Josh, and of course you, Baz. Have a great day.
See you, Tommy.
All right, Tommy.
Thanks, Tommy.
Do you want to thank Outlaw? That's right. Outlaw. Do you want to thank Hubbard at Power Sports, Can-Am, and Sea-Doo in Russellville? Yeah. Glenn and Missy Hubbard, the owners, GM, Montana Bowling. So we appreciate them.
I can't wait for Tommy to get one of them Sea-Doos. That is gonna that's got TikTok written all over it. Justin, Baz and I, if we can work this out, but Baz has to leave, we could build a scaffold to change your light.
Oh my gosh,
room.
Yes.
We've got the stuff here, my friend.
Oh, I gotta tell you guys. This morning, exactly an hour from now, there will be a scissor lift at my house to change all my life.
No!
In your living room?
No!
Yes!
Keep
saying no. Keep saying no.
I love that.
Come on. This will be good. Take this, Josh. Keep saying no.
No! No! No!
Yes!
I'm glad you're getting new lights. It's only been at what?
Three more times.
2 years? No. How long has it been since your lights have been out, Justin?
Yeah.
I love it. Listen, they're so far. You've got a lot of witnesses. You've got natural light. You've got natural light.
All right. Melinda Mayo up next. We're out here in Conway at the Build My Future Conway Expo Center.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Listen every Wednesday when RJ Hawk joins his old buddies on Morning Mayhem, presented by Natural State Wholesale Flooring. See everything that Natural State Wholesale has to offer at naturalstatewholesale.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Night number two of the NBA postseason is in the books. The Philadelphia 76ers are the seventh seed in the Eastern Conference. They beat the Miami Heat 105-104. It was 23 points and 15 rebounds for Joel Embiid, 19 points for Tyrese Maxey, and 20 points for Nicholas Batum off the bench. Miami will host Chicago. The Bulls beat the Atlanta Hawks last night 131-116 to win the second play-in game. A great evening for Kobe White, who had 42 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists. 22 points and 12 boards for Nikola Vucevic, and then 22 points, 9 assists, and 6 boards for DeMar DeRozan. The Bulls and the Heat will meet on Friday night. The winner of that game will play the number one seed Boston Celtics in round number one. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz Weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too. A high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special. Dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, two sides, and our famous salad bar. Only $60. Good. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
All right, everybody, the Zone is on the road once again tomorrow. Yeah, we're going to be at Build My Future event. It's going to be an exciting day out there. We're going to have Jackson Wells on. Thanks to our friends at Thompson Electric. Our Rip Wright Report, talk about some Razorback baseball. That's thanks to Southern Structural Solutions. Barrett Slee will be on, along with Entertainment Report, sponsored by our friends at Bill and Sword. It all starts at 10 a.m. The Zone, where sports and entertainment come crashing together.
Hey, Wilson, where are you heading?
Man, I'm going to see Matt Jones.
I love Matt Jones. You got Miracle on Markham. I'm talking
about Matt Jones, the real Matt Jones, Raj.
The real Matt Jones? Oh, you mean the mortgage expert Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union in Benton.
That's the one.
Did you know that Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU is a Benton boy and a graduate of OBU? So he's very familiar with Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Yep.
Did you know that in addition to being a mortgage lender expert, Matt Jones is also a licensed realtor who can give you insight insight into both sides of your mortgage transaction.
Yeah, I did.
So go see Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU for all your mortgage needs. And if you're looking at buying a new home or need to refinance the home you're already in, the real Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union is your guy. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving all of Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. For more information or to apply securely online, go to alcoacommunityfcu.org. And remember, with the real Matt Jones, miracles can still happen.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
Roger Scott for Gravely Moore is working hard once again, making sure my lawn is lush, weed-free, and beautiful. And by working hard, I mean, of course, I'm watching Bradley Owens mow it for me. Bradley, tell the good folks hello.
Hey, everybody, how's it going?
Stop right there, Bradley. I don't want you to stop what you're doing. What he didn't tell you is that you can take your very own Gravely Moore home today at 0% interest over 48 months. That's right, 0% interest on both residential and commercial mowers. Now, Bradley, tell them where they can go to get their very own Gravely Moore.
Well, you go.
That's enough, my friend. I'll finish it for you at Triple C Sales and Service in Conway, or Lawn and Power in Star City.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Which of Santa's reindeer has the same name as another holiday mascot? Which of Santa's reindeer has the same name as another holiday mascot? Mayor, do you have the answer?
Answer.
What did she say?
She said camp.
All right, very good.
There's not a reindeer named Camp.
Nah, there's just not.
The black sheep of the family.
Oh my god.
Deep on Jessica.
Wow.
Lord.
All right. 8:33. Little Stevie Nicks there. Yeah, little Stevie Nicks there.
Little Stevie Nicks.
Before we go to Melinda real quick, want to check in with Alicia Dover. Alicia, the kids are getting ready to come in any moment, right?
Yes. Some of them are already coming. They're arriving in waves today.
Yes.
And they're going through a safety briefing because they're getting real hands-on experience. They're getting to touch these machines, operate some things. They're even doing a little bit of electrical work. Now, not dangerous
right,
stuff,
right.
But it's stuff that, you know, they're really getting some real experience.
Yeah. Yes. This is the first time this has ever been done in Arkansas. I think it's a great idea. So I'm sure you guys, you know, the it's not you, of course, it's Associated Builders and Contractors of Arkansas. If they are happy with it, I think this will be an annual event, I would imagine.
Absolutely. It's the inaugural event, but I think it's going to keep going because the need for skilled workers is just rising.
Yeah. Yes.
And
yeah.
So, you know, I think it's a great opportunity for high school students to come get inspired too. Maybe they come in thinking they like electrical and then they get the opportunity to try welding here. And then that's what they want to do.
Well, and that's where, all of these jobs have not, they're not being sourced out by AI. You still need live bodies here. You've got to have the folks that can do that.
No AI.
There's no AI welding. You're not going to be able to do that. So it's pretty cool.
Morning Mayhem is fully assembled. I'm David Basil. That's Roger Scott, Justin Moore in the mighty town of Poland. Yeah. And Josh Neighbors back in the studio. Hey, let's go. Would you stick around for a second? Let's visit with your old coworker.
Oh, my goodness. I love Melinda.
Let's go to Melinda Mayo, please, Josh. Hey!
No, Mr. Belafonte, it's Mayo. Mayo, Melinda Mayo. She's Arkansas's TV sweetheart, and she's joining the guys from Morning Mayhem. Melinda Mayo on Morning Mayhem is brought to you by Sanders Ground Essentials, where great lawns start today on the web at sandersground.com.
Good morning, Melinda.
Good morning, guys, and hi, Alicia. We miss you so much, but glad to see that you're doing well. And I just want to say, as the daughter of a builder, construction worker, construction superintendent, my dad raised two girls in our family on those jobs, and they are great vocations to focus on, I think.
Yes, good job on the bell there, Josh. That's exactly right. Melinda, I think we in plus two, as Justin pointed out a few minutes ago, Roger, I think Tommy wants to know about the forecast today, so you'll be also reporting for him today on the weather. Hey, the other thing I want to say real quick, you know, there has been a change at our station in terms of who does weather and news for us throughout the day now. Channel 7 has done it for 20 years, and a lot of people, when that announcement was made, you know, they were worried about one thing, and that we're not going to lose Melinda Mayo, are we? And that the answer is no, that you are with us, and that's not going to change. Same thing with Sully with Out of Bounds. So we're glad that that's going to be the case, Melinda.
Well, thank you for that, and I do so enjoy visiting with you guys. So thank you to everybody who listens in. You can't get rid of me that easily. We do have a line of storm coming through tonight. There is kind of a low-end severe risk with this, kind of like the ones we saw Tuesday, although those were big hail producers. I think these could be more of the damaging wind producers. And this is kind of late tonight. The timing in northwest Arkansas is around 5 to 6 o'clock, probably here about 9 to 10, up to maybe midnight. Some of the models show it kind of weakening as it gets here, so we hope that happens. I think it's a very, very low tornado risk here. It's a little bit more of a tornado risk up in Missouri, Kentucky, Illinois. We don't really have the wind shear here that it takes for that. So hopefully it turns out okay.
The other thing that I saw your notes, I did not know that you created some controversy on Facebook about Coach Cal's outfit choice during the press conference. What happened?
Well, I kind of blame you guys a little bit for this. So I was listening to you guys maybe the day before, the day of, and you were saying, you know, is he going to wear a red blazer? Is he going to wear a red tie?
Right.
A Razorback pullover. So you guys, so I was like, you know what? Let's put that out on Facebook. So I kind of put those options out and had a lot of good comments over what people thought he might wear. And then later, you know, when he comes out in the light gray sport coat and pink shirt, I put that up and said, hey, we didn't really think of this as an option. Well, some people, I guess, took that out of context and thought I was kind of a Cal hater, or I was criticizing the outfit, and I wasn't at all. So, you know, I've just had to kind of learn from you guys, especially you, Baz. You just let that stuff kind of roll.
That's right.
Said, hey, you know, go back and look at what we were talking about before. And I said, if the guys on the bus, including a linebacker, can talk about his clothes, so can we.
Absolutely.
So it was all in good fun. And I'm excited about it being here. I'm excited about Big Z coming in.
Listen, I think what we've seen, that he is not comfortable with red yet. He's not comfortable with changing his wardrobe right now. He's not comfortable calling the Hogs right now, and he doesn't care. And that's fine. I'm not going to, it's not a big hang up
no,
to me.
It's
not. No, I'm saying at some point though, he's got to.
Three words. Endorsement.
I think at some point he's going to make that transition, which I know he will. I think he will. He's smart enough to know.
Well, he needs to know that. What do you want him to wear?
Well, he's got to wear some red. He's got to wear some red.
His whole wardrobe is blue.
That's what I'm saying. So he's still going out wearing a lot of blue, which is fine.
Yeah. Here's my thing. I'm not as concerned with what he's wearing.
Yep.
I mean, I wish he would stop wearing blue.
Yep.
Like, wear a black.
I'm with you. I agree.
You know, but okay, whatever. Just at the end of interviews or whatever, just say go Hawks.
I know.
Yeah.
Prove to me that you're.
Yep.
You're all in.
Yes.
How did you say that, Justin?
Please.
Prove to him that you're what?
All in.
Yeah. You know what? I need something.
Yeah.
I need something.
I know.
I'll even take the sprinkle fingers, but you got to do it right.
How are you on that, Melinda? Are you sprinkle fingers or just moving happy hands?
Calling the Hogs, Melinda.
I think I'm happy hands. When you guys were talking
happy
about
hands.
It, I'm like,
happy hands. She sprinkles.
I think I do the whole hand.
We do the whole hand.
Yeah,
I'm
Alicia,
a sprinkle finger.
Alicia and Justin sprinkle fingers too.
Yeah,
I think that's the appropriate way.
That's what you grew up on.
Well,
that's what the cheerleaders do.
I know.
Thank you.
You're right. So, and I'm going to figure out when it changed.
So they probably teach them correctly.
Well, something happened in the 90s where that changed, because I was at the game.
So let me ask you this, Baz.
Yes.
To your point. When you got to U of A,
yes.
You were from Florida.
Yep.
However many
decades
ago.
Yep.
Did they teach y'all how to do it?
Or? Call the hogs?
No, I don't think we had a form.
So yeah. You just developed your own thing.
We just watched
based
every
on who was around. See,
where cheerleaders. Where yeah, cheerleaders. Yeah, cheerleaders.
So this is a generational thing.
It is.
You go back and ask the original cheerleaders. What'd you say? What'd you say, Justin?
Is it?
Yes. You go back and ask the original cheerleaders. There were no sprinkle fingers
it's
back
generational.
Then.
It's generational. Yeah, Justin, let me show you. Justin, I've got some photographs that I'll send you of the early 70s and the late 60s where the male cheerleaders are tossing up the females and they have a cigarette in their mouth and the smoke has got one of their eyes closed squinting. That's well, what they didn't sprinkle. They smoked.
Can I tell you, I was sitting in the stands in the red and white game. And I looked around. There's probably 5,000-10,000 people there at the max, and the majority of them were doing sprinkle fingers. I said, "I don't belong here. I don't fit in here anymore. Well, I'm an old relic now." That
I guarantee what, you take a poll of who does sprinkle fingers, and I would say this. I won't say everything because it's all subjective. That 75% of people that do sprinkle fingers eat ranch dressing.
Well, I'm gonna tell you this. That
you eat ranch?
Listen,
sure,
Coach Cal. Listen, Coach Cal saw sprinkle fingers. He said, "I'm out."
He's out.
He said, "I'm hopping down off his stage and talking
hey,
to coaches."
He's too much of a man's man to sprinkle.
Melinda, the other thing I want to talk about real quick too. I don't know if you're watching this, Alicia, or you watch it, The Golden Bachelor. I didn't watch it, but it was obviously a national topic. That thing didn't last long. He's already divorced the woman, right? 3 months.
He got what he wanted.
Yeah, surprise. I mean, right. I felt it since I was sort of your Golden Bachelor correspondent this year that I'll just tell you kind of how it wound up. Yeah, so the show wraps up in December. Huge ratings, biggest ratings Bachelor has had in a while. He's both in their 70s, kind of focusing on, you know, so many seniors now who, you know, either have gotten divorces or lost their spouses. So many are single and, you know, they want love too. So they got married in a national broadcast TV wedding in January, and now 3 months later, they're calling it quits.
So
they say that it couldn't work out where to live. You've got kids, you've got grandkids. They want to stay close to their families. There's all kinds of other rumors that she wanted to continue working. She's in finance, and that he didn't. He didn't want her to continue working. He wanted to travel and do all the retirement things. But yeah, so Jerry Turner is now a single man again.
Well, can I tell you, I think in the history of the Bachelor and the Bachelorette, there's only been one couple or two that have remained married. I think it was like year two or year three couple, which was back 20 years ago, I think. Most of these don't work. They'll last,
Krista
right?
Krista and Ryan.
I mean, this is not real love.
That's what I was saying earlier. The Buzz has a better track record with me and Jeremy.
Oh, yeah, true. That's
right. Buzz marriage
that's
right
a,
there.
That's a good point.
Oh, and the other... Ansley and
that's right, Ansley.
Right.
That we sort of
they met through the Buzz as well.
That's right. We sort of started that process with her. Remember what was that called? Not match game. It was a
newlywed.
No, it was
dating game.
Right.
Yeah. How about we sort of forced her to find somebody else?
We sure did.
I do want to thank Sanders Grand Essentials for sponsoring Melinda.
Yeah. And Melinda, since last week, I binged and so did Samantha. We watched Unlocked.
What's that?
Oh yeah, what you think?
What
is it?
Loved it.
What's
loved
Unlocked?
It. It's the series on Netflix that she mentioned last week about Pulaski County.
Oh yes.
First of all, here's the thing that I noticed when they did the hover shot, where the drone shot.
Yeah.
I didn't know the jail was
big. How about that?
It's huge.
Pulaski County is a big county,
dude. Yeah. I think the jail
it's overflowing. It's overflowing.
It's like a maze of different things there. And
do you agree with what? Did you like what you saw?
I don't know where I am on it right now. I dig some of the rehab that needs to be done if they can do that. And when you see some of the recidivism that happens with some of these cats, you see where drugs were a big part of their lives early on.
Some of
them are in there for murder and what. Got an 18, 19 year old kid. His life's over. He's going to be spending the rest of his life in prison. You see some of this stuff, but I think there needs to be so much more done to try to get to kids early. But no, before they even go.
Oh,
there,
yeah, without question.
Drugs are horrible because here's the thing. And then when you get out, where do you go? Because you don't, you have to go back to the same place where you grew up and all that, and you fall right into the same trap. So I applaud them for what they're trying to do. Don't know where I stand, good, bad, or indifferent yet, but I applaud that.
Melinda?
Yeah. This is kind of an experiment. Yeah. And I think Sarah Higgins is coming off very likable on the show, that he's trying to just see if this works, to give them a little bit more freedom within the facility and saying, hey, you guys figure it out. You guys learn how to form a community. And if you can do that, we'll let you roam around a little bit more instead of staying behind a locked door for 23 hours a day. It's been really highly rated on Netflix, one of the highest rated shows.
And let me tell you this, the cats in there who can build tattoo tools, make ink out of ash, and build wicks out of paper towels and everything, they need to come here and use their skill of that and learn how to do some of this stuff and start their own gig. It's amazing that necessity is the mother of all invention, and they're doing it in jail. And it really was tough to watch. But anyway, thanks for that recommendation.
Melinda, real quick before we let you go, I didn't realize the Razorbacks are playing next Tuesday in Dickie Stevens. Yeah. Who are we playing next?
Absolutely.
Who are we playing?
It's UAPB, isn't it?
I believe so.
Is that right?
Yeah, UAPB.
UAPB, yeah.
Awesome.
Next Tuesday night, I love this game that they come to Dickie Stevens. You know, a lot of people can't get up to Fayetteville for games at Vaughn Walker. And the U of A really does a great job at bringing as much of the spirit of that down here. They bring the mascots and the souvenirs. So, you know, if you've got a kid who loves baseball and loves the Razorbacks, you know, take them out. It's Tuesday night at Dickie Stevens. They're playing UAPB. Sometimes you don't see all the starters. You don't see the starting pitchers for that game. It just depends on what Dave Van Horn wants to do. But it'll be a fun night, and I'll be there calling the Hogs with, hey, you know what? I'm going to call it Jazz Hands.
Jazz.
Yeah, we're Jazz Hands. We're Jazz Hands.
That'll work. All right, thank your sponsor, Melinda.
For sure, Sanders Brown, the Essentials, Kent, and Kyle. I tell you what, they know it's going to rain tonight, so they're probably out putting fertilizer today.
They are.
Because they watch the weather, they make sure that they do it when it needs to be done. They've also got the mosquito barrier spray happening right now, because you know those cedars are coming if they're not already out, so they can do that as well and keep you from those all summer long. So give them a call, 315-9395, sandersbrown.com. And it's good to hear from my buddy Alicia, boy mom.
Oh, Melinda, I was going to say before we go, you're our queen, and I miss you so much. And I want to say, too, that I just learned so much from you through my years at Channel 7, and you're just an inspiration to women in broadcasting, women in science, in meteorology. She is a legend, and we get to be around her and learn from her.
And if I may be so bold, Justin, will you help me on this? And she's a smoke show to boot.
Yes, she is.
You guys are
beauty and brains.
So all right, Mel. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. We appreciate it. Go Hogs.
Go Hogs. Hey, go Hogs. Listen, Melinda has said go Hogs more than Calipari.
I know. You're right. At least it looks like the kids are coming in.
Yeah, they're starting to flood in here.
They got the goodie bags. They got their vest on, and they're ready to go. They're learning.
Yeah, you can see over here too. They've got fall protection over here.
Yes, so I mean lives are changing right before our eyes, Roger.
This is the
All right, 8:48. We'll be back in just a minute.
Hey folks, it's David Basil out here at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood. It's Ram Truck Month, and Fletcher Dodge has big discounts on new Rams. Up to $11,000 off new Ram 2500s and up to $10,000 off new half-ton Ram. But that's not all. They've got 0% financing on new Ram Bighorns for 72 months. Or how about $10,000 off new Jeep Gladiators? And they have new 2024 Jeep Compass 4x4s for only $424 a month with zero down and no gimmicks. They're getting new inventory every week, so come in and let them know what you're looking for. They're ready to make you a deal on a new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, or Ram. And don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see their credit professionals at Fletcher Dodge and let them help you get into a new vehicle to get you to work or school. For the best selection, lowest price, and best buying experience, go see my friends at Fletcher Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Sherwood. Or you can shop online at FletcherDeals.com. It's Ram Truck Month, and Fletcher Dodge has big discounts on new Rams.
Connor has cash. Once again, Connor has cash at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack in Conway. Connor will buy your used weapon, or he will buy your entire collection. Once again, Connor has cash, and he wants to buy your used weapons at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack, Highway 65 North in Conway. Stiefel Financial presents Razorback pitcher Hagen Smith when he gets in the zone each week with Justin and DJ. Stiefel Financial, with branches in Little Rock, Hot Springs, and Fort Smith, serving clients since 1890.
It's time to bring legendary Kubota reliability to your hayfield. Heavy-duty balers, disc mower conditioners, rakes, tedders, and wrappers to fit your specific crop and condition. Match them up with one of Kubota's ag tractors. The M7 line ranges in horsepower from 128 to 168 with premium hydraulics and multiple transmission options to finish any job. Henard Foothills Equipment, South Main Street in Searcy, your hometown Kubota dealer no matter where you live. 501-268-1987.
Hi, I'm Hunter Bell from Bell Chevrolet, and I want to tell you the real reason it's better at Bell. Our people, our family, and our community that drives us to be the best. We're proud to offer our biggest inventory and lowest prices on every single vehicle, from the all-new Silverado to the all-electric Chevy Equinox. We're going to find you the perfect vehicle with a buying experience like nowhere else. Our commitment is to you every day. Shop Bell Chevrolet and BellChevrolet.com today. Together, let's drive.
Crawfish season is finally back at Eat My Catfish. We've got fresh, live crawfish, and all you have to do is just add the fixins. Be sure to come see us or order online at EatMyCatfish.com. Eat local, eat fresh, eat my catfish.
Tune in each week on Morning Mayhem as Boat Mattingly joins the guys and gives his behind-the-scenes look that he gets from his relationship with the University of Arkansas. Thanks to UAMS Health, the official orthopedics and sports medicine provider for Razorback Athletics.
Today is the day. After countless hours of research, cutting back expenses, and 9 months of anxiously waiting for her, today is the day you finally bring home your new car. It's also the day to protect her with an auto policy from Shelter Insurance. Our policies are competitively priced and include new car replacement coverage if anything were to happen to your new baby.
See Dan Cook in North Little Rock, Steve Fisher in Stuttgart, or Jay Vandover in Little Rock.
Do you recycle? Sure you do. Or you'd like to. Recycling is easy because you don't have to separate recyclable material. We'll do that for you. Just throw it in the cart, loose, no bagging. To do recycling right, you need to know what should go in your cart and what shouldn't. To learn more, go to mydoright.com. At mydoright.com, we'll show you how to do recycling right. Do right and do it the right way.
It's the Average Guy Movie Review, Thursdays in the Zone with Justin and DJ, presented by Rock and Roll Sushi. The guys will recap or look ahead to what's trending on TV, the big screen, Netflix, or however you receive your TV service. Presented by Rock and Roll Sushi, deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that will blow your mind. Rockandrollsushi.com.
Always make sure to say please and thank you. Morning Mayhem is back on the air, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Let's play a game, all right? On the count of three, name your favorite dinosaur. Don't even think about it. Just name it. Ready? One, two, three.
Velociraptor.
Favorite non magazine to
two.
Good housekeeping. If you were a chick, who's the one guy you would sleep with?
John Stamos.
What? Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
I love that. 853 here in Conway at the Conway Expo Center.
I love looking at the YouTube video, Justin.
Yes.
Whenever I play a clip that I know that Baz likes, and I just see the little smile going on his face, I just hear the
well,
Beavis and Butthead. It's hilarious.
Speaking of Beavis and Butthead, did you guys see
Yes.
This? Yes. Yes.
On SNL.
Yes, hilarious.
Last week. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That's one of the best I've seen in years.
Yeah.
Yes. It's one of the funniest skits they've done. Yeah.
It was brilliant.
So good.
Well, Justin, the reason we played that clip is National Velociraptor Day. No joke. It is National Velociraptor Day. Of course, we go straight to Step Brothers with that. And so,
what movie is a velociraptor most synonymous with?
I think it's Step Brothers.
Jurassic Park.
Jurassic Park. Boom.
Which one was that in Jurassic Park? I don't remember.
It's the first one, right? There's a pack of raptors, aren't there?
I think it's a couple of them.
Aren't they the ones that do the hunting? Hunting.
Yeah, because remember, I think in the they're in that like domed room in the end.
Yes.
And
okay, those
all
are the
raptors are chasing. Oh, no. They're in that laboratory.
Yeah, that's what I remember.
And the
that.
Raptors come out. It's horrifying.
I don't know about you guys, but maybe it's my age, like because it came out when I was
at
a certain age. I love Jurassic Park.
I like them too.
They're awesome.
I don't know why
they were on the cutting edge at the time. We hadn't seen the ability to have
dinosaurs that looked that real when the technology improved. Just got a couple minutes here for I got to get out of here. Justin, the reason Justin's not playing this weekend, you've got your golf tournament next Monday and your private deal Sunday night. So we'll be at what's that? Lord, come on.
One of those times where I'm gonna,
it does it. It happens.
That's going to be on Roger's if I'm not mistaken, that's what I was trying to say.
Yes.
I think this is our fifth year maybe to do our St. Jude thing.
That sounds about right.
The show Sunday night, golf tournament Monday, and we're going to do our show Monday, and I'm going to try to be there Monday.
I know.
On a Monday.
I know. I know. How about that?
People are out there going, God dang it. I thought we had all.
No. Here's one. Speaking of, Johnny Sauce says, I can't stop myself from yelling random words in the form of a question when I hear them now. I just yelled scissor lift out loud in my car, then looked to make sure no one else was in there with me. So we've created something there.
Yes.
Someone said, absolutely love y'all's show. Love getting to meet you at Edwards. Still feel like I'm listening to my friends in the morning. Thank you so much there. JK says, Justin has the fever. Justin has the fever. Not sure what that's all about.
Well, he just got that's it. The Christopher Walken.
Well, I knew that, but I'm just saying.
More cowbell.
I just wonder why did Justin say something that makes him think he's got the fever? Here's one that says Cal can wear a blue suit the night we win the national championship if he wants to. It doesn't matter.
I'm fine with whatever he wears. He better just say go Hogs or
yeah. We gotta have more of that. Yeah.
Somebody says never understood why Baz is so anti sprinkle finger. I'm not. I'm just saying.
I think it's an effeminate thing.
It feels as manly, and that's what I think. Cal looked at it and go, really? Can I just raise my hands and raise my arms and move my hands a little
real
bit?
Real men don't
I'm
sprinkle.
Confident in my master.
right. I see, and I figure that's where Baz was going because again, it took over 50 years before he would let anybody, a female, drive him.
That is true. All right, boys, I'm headed down to Dallas.
All right.
We will be at the Kaufman.
Another week you're taking off Earth.
How about that?
I have so much time.
Everybody gives me so much crap.
I have so much confidence in you and Roger. You get to talk with Will McIntyre.
Yeah, we are.
You don't even need me for Willie.
Yeah, here we go again.
All right, boys. You guys have a good one. We'll be tomorrow at Kaufman Design Center. Tonight, you got trivia.
Trivia down at Mainline Sports
in Oakland
Park. Yeah,
tonight.
Come on, hang
yes.
out with us again. Yeah.
All right.
We'll miss
That's
you,
it.
But
I'm taking off tomorrow.
I'll be back Monday.
Live from Build My Future here at the Conway Expo Center. It's 9 o'clock.
All right.
Rock out with American-style sushi experience founded on great food, true love, and rock and roll.
Rock and roll sushi.
Deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that'll blow your mind.
Rockandrollsushi.com.
Now with 5 locations in central Arkansas.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections. And explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at Arkansas.com.
Mark your calendar for the Criminal Justice Institute Strike Out Opioids Day at the Arkansas Travelers Game on April 20th. Explore the Arkansas Overdose Prevention Program booth for essential prevention resources and learn about naloxone. Dive deeper at narcansaw.com.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
Sports.
Sports. Sports.
We've got that wood.
I got that wood.
And much more than you can handle on 103.7 The Buzz. KABC Little Rock.
Buzz News with KARK's Claire Kreitz.
Four men were arrested for a shooting that killed one person and hurt nine others in Wynn. Quavarius Millen, Carl Washington, Cameron Crawford, and Tommy Frost are facing several charges, including first-degree murder. Arkansas legislators are working to amend the state's current crypto mining law. Two of the eight resolutions presented on the House floor passed yesterday. The current law allows local governments to have control over crypto mining sites and put a stop to them. The resolutions passed aim to expand that, giving the city and county governments control over the sites once they're built. An Arkansas woman received a national award for her work following the tornado that hit Wynn last year. Leanne Lovell founded the Wynn Relief and Recovery Organization. She established a distribution center, brought in doctors and counselors, and secured temporary housing. This is Claire Kreitz for the Buzz Radio Network.
Insure your auto, home, life, and everything in between with Shelter Insurance. Find a local agent by calling 1-800-SHELTER or at shelterinsurance.com.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz Weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too, a high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler, drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special, dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, two sides, and our famous salad bar. Only $60. Good Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Join Morning Mayhem Friday for the Spring Spectacular at Kaufman by Design West. Celebrate with a chance to win a large green egg, steel blower with a trimmer, or a $700 flooring credit. Register in person or on Facebook with Kaufman by Design West. It's Morning Mayhem Friday at Kaufman by Design West on Highway 10, just past Taylor Loop Road.
As we gather under the gentle April sun, let us all share an important message from our law enforcement officials. From April 19th to April 21st, Arkansas will witness a collective effort to safeguard our roads during the Drive High, Get a DWI Blitz. Now, this isn't just about enforcement. It's about protecting each other. Like a vigilant guardian, law enforcement is stepping up to curb drug-impaired driving, ensuring the safety of every traveler. Whether obtained legally or otherwise, driving while under the influence poses a grave danger to all of us. It threatens not only the driver, but also their passengers and fellow road users. Our roads should be pathways to cherished destinations, not scenes of tragedy. It's a simple truth. Impaired driving, be it from alcohol or drugs, endangers lives. THC, the compound responsible for marijuana's effects, slows reaction times and clouds judgments. If you feel different, you drive different. Drive high, get a DWI. Let's drive with care, Arkansas, for in our hands lies the power to save lives. A message from the Arkansas Highway Safety Office.
Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool and Spa 20% off store wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakwasil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool and Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool and Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
RJ Hawk here with Chris Roberts from Southern Bank. And Chris, you know, we've talked so much about that hometown feel and what it's like at Southern Bank. But if you're a commercial investor, they need to come talk to you.
We're involved with a lot of customers that have projects across the United States. Those projects can be some of the biggest projects you'd see in your communities. So really, there's no project that's too large for us to look at.
If somebody's interested in learning more about what Southern Bank can do for their commercial investments, how do they get in touch with you?
You just pick up the phone. phone and call me at 501-424-0900. Just love to talk to you about your project, see what you've got going on, and see how we can be a help to you.
And you talk about being a help. You really invest into your commercial investors by helping them through the process, looking at things to look out for along the way.
I like to think we can throw things off of each other, listen to different viewpoints, and come to the best decision.
If you want to learn more, go online, bankwithsouthern.com, or call Chris, 424-0900, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritoons, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
At Kubota, we want to help you deliver a job done right. That's why we want you to know that new Kubota inventory is arriving daily. You have work to do. We have the reliable, durable, and versatile lineup to help you do it. Visit River Valley Tractor today for all your equipment needs. Visit your local River Valley Tractor dealer. www.rivervalleytractor.com.
Political strategist and host of the Sunday Buzz, Bill Vickery, gets in the mix with the guys on Morning Mayhem, brought to you by Sauce Bar and Oven. Online at saucelr.com and by the Butcher Shop Steakhouse, home of the best steak and prime rib in all of Little Rock.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
I want your blood. I want your soul.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
I want them both right now.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
I'm your Huckleberry.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, Lunger, let's do it.
We are live. It's the last hour of the show. Roger Scott here at the Build My Future event going on at Conway Expo Center. A lot of folks coming in. Just saw Ricky Brooks just stop by with Robert McNulty. Been listening to the show forever. Tells me stories about anytime somebody comes up to me and says, man, I met you in Basil. I met y'all, blah, blah, blah. And Roger, you probably don't remember me. I met you about 20 years ago. And I go, oh, my gosh, it could be anything. It could be anything. But fortunately, I haven't been that much of a jerk to a lot of people, or at least the ones that come up to me don't tell me.
Raj, is that not one of the most intimidating, scariest things you've ever dealt with?
Yes, sir.
When somebody goes, I met you like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
And I always cringe and go, oh, gosh.
Uh-oh.
Hey, here's what I say. I go, was I nice?
Oh, dude. Yeah, dude, that is it. I mean, it is for me. It's one of those things where I'd like to think that I've been nice to anybody else that's nice. I had a guy come up to
me. Of course.
Yeah, somebody that came up.
Sometimes you just don't know. You're
out on the golf course.
That's my perspective.
Well, you know, help me out with this, Josh, and then we'll go to we'll get Will McIntyre. Excuse me, Justin, help me out with this. And Josh, you may have an answer as well. Then we'll go to Will McIntyre at the golf tournament the other day. Thanks to everybody that came out and supported us and all that. One guy came up to me and Baz when we were on one of the hosts and says, hello to Basil, yada, yada, yada. And then goes and then just extended his hand to me. Nice guy, super nice guy. He says, I met Roger a few years ago. Saw him at the Edwin Watts Golf Store, this and that, and I went, hey, Roger Scott, and he just went, hey, man, I I'm thinking, I don't know what to do. I don't know if you want me to come up and just and go, hey, Roger Scott, damn glad to meet you, Rush Chairman, that type of thing. I don't know what you
Rush Chairman.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. And when you go, hey, and you keep walking, and I just keep walking, what should I do? I mean. Obviously, Justin, you're on a different level.
This also reminds me of another thing. Like, I wonder how you guys, Josh and Raj, handle this, because I've changed my approach, I guess, over the years as I've gotten a little bit older. Like, when somebody goes, you remember me? Mm-hmm. And I used to go, yeah, of course, man. It's been a while.
Yeah.
And then I'd get, oh, man, I saw you last week.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh.
That's so, it can be terrible.
People come up nowadays and go, which I think that's one of the more rude things you can do is go, you remember me?
Because you're putting somebody in the spot.
I think that's very rude.
Yeah, because it's not.
My opinion.
There's been a couple really times.
But, yeah. So now I go, if I don't remember you, whoever you is, I go, man, I could lie to you and tell you I do, but I'm not going to do that. I don't. I don't remember you.
No, I'll leave it. Yeah, well, I'll leave it. I'll leave it. We can talk about that as well, and I'll do the same thing. I'll go, you know what? I got to be honest with you. Please forgive me for not remembering, and then we'll do that. We'll talk more about that here in a little bit. We'll get Alicia back on as well while we're here at the Build My Future Expo. But we've got to welcome in right now to the show. If it's Thursday at 9 o'clock, it's time for Will McIntyre.
He's a Central Arkansas native who's taking his talents to the hill to help the Hogs on the mound. It doesn't matter what the situation is. He's always ready to take the ball for the Razorbacks. Brought to you by Seth Boyd with Shelter Insurance. Give Seth a call today for all your insurance needs. 501-982-6465. Joining Morning Mayhem, it's number 41, Will McIntyre.
It is Will McIntyre on the show. Hello, Will.
Morning.
Man, I got to tell you, I appreciate Seth Boyd for stepping up. But we've got a couple of sponsors, and here's another tangent I go off on. Pickup Truck Accessories. I love them and thank them. But in my head, I hear the spot go, Hiccup Truck. And with Seth Boyd, I can't help but go a little step further and go, Chef Boyd RD is what I keep hearing. I keep hearing Chef Boyd RD. But it's Seth Boyd Shelter Insurance. We appreciate them. Will, well, the last time we...
Speaking of,
yeah, go ahead, Justin.
I'm sorry. Speaking of pickup truck accessories, just to, in an attempt to get to know you better as a person, what do you drive?
I drive a Chevy Silverado.
Pickup. There you go. All right.
I guess if you, I guess if you just say that, that's like saying Skinner. He drives a Chevy. You don't say you drive a Chevy if you drive a if you're driving a Charger, or if you're driving a whatever else. What do you call those other vehicles? What's a fast car? The fast two vehicle or two Corvette? Yeah, vet. You say vet. Corvette, you don't say Mustang. Yeah. You don't say yeah. You'll say that car. You won't say the Chevy. So if you go Chevy, that just means you're a pickup guy. Well, Will, we've got a few things to talk about. Some not so good news, but some very good news. Last time we talked to you, we get the bad stuff out of the way. Last time we talked to you, I believe it was the Alabama series, and it did not go as well as we wanted. You got any thoughts on that last series with Alabama?
Yeah, just the series didn't really go our way. We didn't really play our best as a team, and you just got to move on to the next thing and get over it. Baseball, you know, you're not going to win every game, every series. So you just got to move on to the next thing.
Well, we as fans, we expect you guys to already have your speeches ready and who you're going to thank after the World Series championship. That's who we are as fans. That's who the Razorback fans are. That's what we do. We're already there. I had a couple of folks come up to me and if you guys aren't winning and I mean, you're number one in the country, and now you're number two, but at that time, you're number one. And a lot of folks started, several guys came up to me and said, man, it doesn't look like they're, it looks like they're a little tuckered out, or maybe they're just going through some motions. What do you say to us fans who think, say something like that? You're trying your ass off, trying your heart out to win that series with Alabama, and we've got fans that'll go, man, it just looks like they're going through the motions, or maybe their heart's not in it, or maybe they think they should win. You got any comment to any of that?
I just say, like, you know, we play 60 games in a season, and we try and show up for all of them and just be consistent. And with playing that many games, there's just going to be games where, like, it's just not going to go your way, and you might just get beat, or you beat yourself in a game, and just got to move on and keep playing how you play and just don't change what you're doing.
Well, we appreciate that as a fan. We appreciate you moving on to the next game because as fans, we like to harp on. It's real easy for us to keep up with the negative stuff. It's so easy to bring that emotion out. But then we move on, and you did move on, and you've got a 25-game winning streak going on at Baum Stadium right now. What's it like being there? You were just there, and you took that midweek series against the Texas Tech Red Raiders. What's it like playing there at Baum with your team and the fans?
It's definitely got to be a tough environment to come into in a midweek. It was pretty packed crowd both games, and I feel like midweeks are sometimes hard to get up for. But I feel like we did a really good job. And just that environment helps for sure, and it's definitely a home field advantage.
Go ahead.
Will, I made the point yesterday that I thought it was probably good for you guys to have an opponent like Texas Tech come in for a midweek two-game set after the Bama series instead of, you know, not to diminish any other program, but instead of a non-Power 5 program. I thought that's probably good for them. They got to really focus in and get ready. Is that true or no?
Yeah, definitely. That team was a really good offense and really good team overall. And I think it was just a big confidence boost for us after losing the series to Alabama to coming home and winning the two games against a really good Texas Tech team. And that kind of just brings the momentum to our side going into this weekend.
So, Will, you've been lights out. I mean, most of the season, you've been lights out. Last three outings for you, I mean, you've given up basically the same amount of runs you had the entire season, right? So, for you, do you feel like you're doing what you normally do? Or, you know, do you feel like you're in a rough patch? What do you think for this last week? Just because, I mean, you've been so good. It's almost odd to see you give up a run or two.
It's frustrating for sure, but it's just baseball, and it's a tough sport. Sometimes it's a very unrewarding sport, and you just got to move on and, you know, make adjustments here and there. Maybe I'm doing something, I'm throwing one pitch too much, or maybe it's just the ball's not going my way and it's just their day. But you just got to move on and keep doing what you're doing and just not let it get to you.
Yeah, to Josh's point, I could see after you gave up the home run on the first pitch in game one, coming off, then you didn't give up anymore. But you could tell how frustrated you were with giving up even just one run. Was that a pitch that was supposed to be buried on the back foot inside?
It was supposed to be more in on the hand, and I kind of just feel like he kind of ambushed that pitch because that's one of my primary pitches. Yeah, he kind of probably knew that was coming, and I wasn't even mad about giving us the home run. I was just more mad that, like, the team fought back from being down six, seven runs, and as soon as I come in, first pitch of my outing, I give up the lead, and it actually was a tied game, so I blew the tied game, and I was just frustrated with myself because late in the game, you can't as a pitcher be getting beat full side. You need to get beat in a different way, and you can't let them just explode right there.
Well, buddy, like you said, that's baseball. It happens. But yeah. Out of curiosity, just from a strategy standpoint, because we were talking about it over a text thread, were you on a pitch limit Tuesday night? Or in secondary question, did you use that instead of like maybe a bullpen session to get ready for the weekend, or how does that kind of work?
So like with a double midweek, you kind of just need everybody to be able to pitch because you need enough innings for 18 innings and, you know, some cases maybe extra innings. And so I was able to get some innings out there, and I was on a shorter pitch count just so I didn't overextend myself, so I would be able to be fresh and ready to go this weekend.
You know, Will, I watching yesterday's game, and we're all on a delay. We are all four of us in a different location, so apologize for the delay if we're jumping in on that. But last night watching the ball game, or yesterday afternoon, I guess it was yesterday afternoon, the sun was beating down. And I got to thinking, if I could see a few of the guys out there that were wearing sunglasses, even with the glasses on, it was difficult to catch a ball. I think Stovall dropped one, if I saw correctly. Do you pitch with glasses, sunglasses? I didn't hear you. Do you wear sunglasses?
I wear them in the dugout, but pitchers don't really wear them while they pitch.
I didn't. You know what? I was trying to see that, and I couldn't tell because the hats were so low. I was trying to think. Well, that would just be the depth perception would be way off on that. So I was just curious if you wear that. So you will never do that, and you really don't need to, because
I don't think y'all are allowed to, right? Because it could reflect back to the hitters.
I would assume so.
Is that right?
I've never really seen it. The only time I see somebody wearing something on the mound on their eyes, like glasses.
Right, like Rex Packs.
Yeah, if you have. Yeah. Okay, gotcha. Well, I was curious about that. I thought I don't know if I could do that. I don't even know if I could do it out. But if you've been doing it for long enough, I guess you get used to it. Well, we move on now. We've got another conference series coming up starting Friday with South Carolina. Number 2 Arkansas takes on, I think, number 20 South Carolina. Any thoughts on that series coming up?
And what are y'all facing, Will, in a lineup?
We hadn't really gone over scouting report. We'll go over that tomorrow morning. But it's a good team. If it's the same team as last year, it's gonna be a tough series. And it's one of the last ballparks I haven't been to in the SEC, and I've heard it's a tough environment to play in, so it'll be a good challenge.
Well, we're going to be looking forward to that one then, just based on what you just said. If you hadn't been there before, we'll try to keep an eye on that. Will, before we let you go, I'll ask you a couple of other questions, but I got to let everybody know your goal is of 12K for Carti. We're still a little bit shy of that, so tell people how they can make donations for you to help out with Carti.
So they could go to my Instagram or my Twitter bio, and they should both be W_McIntyre. And there's just a link where you could pledge or do a one-time donation. And so for like every strikeout I get this year, I'm donating $5 of my own money to the Carti Cancer Center of Arkansas. And it's just going to a good cause. It's a personal cause, and I think everybody could support that cause.
It's a great no. Seriously, it's a great cause. And when you're doing that, we don't hear a lot of the athletes when they do something like that. We don't give enough credit when things like that are being done. And you're still in college, and you're doing that. And yes, $5 right now is a lot of money for a lot of people. And if you can go to that, folks, please support Will on this. Support him. Support Carti. It is a fantastic cause. And do that for every strikeout. Another $5. You can match that. Couple of things here, guys, if you want to throw it in. Will, here it is. It is National Animal Cracker Day. Do you eat animal crackers?
No, but my little nephew, who is about – I don't know, a year and a half, he absolutely loves those things.
So are you too big for animal crackers now, or you just never grew up with them?
No, I definitely think they're probably a good snack. I just hadn't had them in forever.
Well, listen, it's not a lot. If you got to go down the cookie aisle to do that, and I don't know if you're going down the cookie aisle, especially during the season. It's also International Jugglers Day. Do you juggle, or is there something that you do that we wouldn't expect? I mean, are you juggling? Are you spinning the top? Are you
playing guitar?
Playing guitar, anything like that?
Oh man, I don't think I have any really hidden talents.
No hidden talents, right? Because we know what you can do on the mound. Well, Will, we appreciate you coming on with us and being a part of our show. We really enjoy getting to know you a little bit more and talking to you. You're one of our guys, and we look forward to speaking with you again next week.
Thanks for having me.
All right, there he goes, everybody. Will McIntyre with Seth Boyd. I'm telling you, I can't say it without
thinking Chef YRD.
Exactly. Chef,
whatever it is.
That's exactly
it. Was it Chef Boyd?
Chef Boy RD.
Boy RD, is that what it is?
It's Chef.
Or whatever it is, like Josh, like you don't know what that is?
I know what it is. I don't know. Like, it's one of those things where you hear it, but, like, you never actually thought about how it's pronounced or said or spelled.
Yeah.
Have you eaten it?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It
well,
is.
Well, I ahead. Don't think I have, actually. But, I mean, I know what it is.
What? No, listen. That is gross to him. Chef Boyardee.
Do you know what my mother's last name is? Do you think we ate that in my house? Yeah.
No,
I think the Ready,
exactly.
The Ready House was not going that direction. Jeff,
no, they are not doing that at all. They're going straight.
McDonald's. a kid, like, you gotta eat SpaghettiOs and ravioli.
Homemade, baby. Homemade. That's the route that we went.
You're four?
Yeah, well, I mean, we didn't eat a whole lot of pasta, but when we did, it was the homemade legit stuff.
Well, and I think we had a little bit of it growing up.
Hey, Tommy.
Yo,
Bones.
Yo,
Mr. Bones. Hey, this kid was blessed. You hear me?
He was.
He had homemade pasta straight out of his mother. Homemade pasta.
Let me tell you something about this, my little country western singing friend. This kid here, Josh, his mother's breast milk had sauce in it. That's how Italian he is. You following me?
Hey, you and me, we were eating SpaghettiOs.
Oh. Okay. Oh. You know what? Somebody just asked. We're gonna have to get the Goombas to do a movie deal with Step Brothers as well. Here's one for you.
I was just thinking we should do Step Brothers.
We're gonna. I'll
you're gonna have to call me Nighthawk. Hey.
I'll get you. There's so many cuss words in that movie. We'll have to find the right one when it's just the two brothers.
Hey, did we just become best friends?
Oh, Velociraptor. Hey.
Not for nothing, but hey, I think we just became best friends.
Forget about it.
Wait, Roger, you did the Fredo scene earlier. I watched Godfather 2 last night.
Yeah. Oh, you did.
It's crazy.
That's who Baz thinks I am. It's Fredo when he goes, can you believe this? Roger got an answer right. But then we go over here to our text line. D3 text line, and the guy goes, good grief. My God, have you guys ever seen a baseball game? I love you all, and the show is great, but let McIntyre have a break for crying out loud. Sunglasses on a pitcher? No. Well, I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. First of all, I don't understand what the break was. I don't know. I don't know where
I didn't know that until high school either. I just learned when I pitched in high school that they didn't want you wearing glasses.
Did he put a name? Was that a text?
No, did not. It's from the 501.
Please, sir or ma'am, whomever. Please text back in with your name, and I will do a contest with you on air, and I'll put up $1,000 that I know more about baseball than you do.
Oh! Put your money where your mouth is.
Promise you.
Don't use that mouth to kiss my kids goodnight. All right. Oh, is that a break? Did you just go to a break? Hey, we'll do that. Yeah. Here's one for you right here. You know what? And then there's this person right here. Roger, you and Justin have become way better at interviews since the Bob Moore days. Thank you. See, it weighs it out right there.
Because the rest of them have been nice.
Bob scared us.
No, Bob was a nice person.
Of course he was.
We're intimidated.
Well, you know what? And there's different cats on there. They've never done it before. It is. And it's also one of those things where, Bob was new, or Robert Moore was new at doing interviews as well on radio. I mean, I assume they didn't do a whole lot of that back then.
I will say, watching Baz has helped me, too. Watching Baz has helped me, too, because he's so good at interviewing people.
Well, Baz is...
Well, the thing is, what folks out there don't realize, like, Baz is the quarterback. Like,
yeah.
So we just kind of play off of him.
Yeah, exactly.
So and he allowed... we have to do the whole thing without him, it's... That intimidates me.
No, there's no doubt. There's no doubt because he allows that. But let me tell you, he is that good. Baz is one of the best interviewers. Howard Stern's fantastic. But yep. Howard gets
and Patrick.
Howard Stern gets an hour and a half. And Patrick as well. Justin, I've heard your podcast as well. And when you're in your groove, there's not something you don't know about. So obviously you're an intelligent cat. So when you do interviews, it's outstanding. I get intimidated by everybody. Like I said, I'm still intimidated. With high school coaches when I was doing the referee job just a couple of years ago. I had to get out of there because I was having
I think it's my low T, probably.
It's your what? Your what?
Huh? What?
He's a low T.
We're not. But anyway, Baz is great, and we miss him, and we appreciate him being a part. We love being a part of the morning show. We got 30 minutes left in this, and we couldn't do it without some of the folks that have come up and met us. so far this morning, and they're piling in now. You can go on our cameras and see all the students that are coming in and going here at the Build My Future Expo here in Conway. We'll get Alicia Dover on, and we'll get Bill Rochelle back on with us when we come back, and we'll find out more about what's going on here. And maybe you can be a part of it, if not this year, next year as well. It is Morning Mayhem. Roger Scott, Justin Moore, Josh Neighbors, David Basil, somewhere on the highways and byways of Arkansas. We'll be right back.
The only thing that keeps me hanging out. The only thing that keeps me hanging out.
Tickets are on sale now for the 20th annual Double B's Buzzbecue, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Go to buzzbecue.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Night number two of the NBA postseason is in the books. The Philadelphia 76ers are the 7th seed in the Eastern Conference. They beat the Miami Heat 105-104. It was 23 points and 15 rebounds for Joel Embiid, 19 points for Tyrese Maxey, and 20 points for Nicholas Batum off the bench. Miami will host Chicago. The Bulls beat the Atlanta Hawks last night 131-116 to win the second play-in game. A great evening for Kobe White, who had 42 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists. 22 points and 12 boards for Nikola Vucevic, and then 22 points, 9 assists, and 6 boards for DeMar DeRozan. The Bulls and the Heat will meet on Friday night. The winner of that game will play the number one seed Boston Celtics in round number one. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center.
Buzz weather with KARK's Pat Walker.
There's a 40% chance of rainfall today. It's going to be another warm, humid day, too. A high of 85 degrees. Tonight, the chance of severe weather, mainly a damaging wind threat, as a line of thunderstorms could move through. It's an 80% chance of rain. Overnight, it'll get much cooler. We'll drop to 56 by tomorrow morning. For the Buzz Radio Network, I'm meteorologist Pat Walker.
Riverfront Steakhouse Special. Dinner for two for $60. 10-ounce filet, fried shrimp, 2 sides, and our famous salad bar. Only $60. Good Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Did you know 21 people fall victim to overdose every minute? The Parker Gill Foundation believes a combination of prevention and recovery efforts are vital to ending opioid-related overdose deaths. How can you help? You can make a cash donation or bid on a raffle item. Log on to ParkerGillFoundation.org to view and bid on auction items. Help save lives from overdose in Arkansas. For more details on tournament or foundation mission, go to ParkerGillFoundation.org.
Calling all coaches! Summerwood Sports and Bryant, it's your go-to destination for basketball and volleyball tournaments, practices, and more. Conveniently located off Interstate 30, it's the premier sports complex in Central Arkansas. With up to 4 courts and 2 gyms, Summerwood Sports is perfect for training sessions, team practices, and even epic birthday parties. Check availability and learn more at summerwoodsports.com. Elevate your game at Summerwood Sports.
Pay attention, this happens fast. You're on the forklift in your warehouse when it breaks down. You call Medley Equipment Company. Talk to Debbie.
Hello.
Debbie tells you they'll get you moving again. Debbie talks to a service tech.
Yep, I can do it.
Tech says when they can be there. That nice Debbie lady calls you back.
Hello.
Saying your forklift will be fixed in a few hours.
Nice.
Pretty fast, right? We're just trying to keep up, because Medley keeps you moving.
I'm branch manager Jeff Peps. Visit MedleyCompany.com or come see us at 121 House Court, North Little Rock, Arkansas.
Hi, it's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge Store here in Sherwood. Folks, if you're shopping for a new car or truck, I hope you'll come see us and give us a chance to earn your business. We have huge discounts, 0% financing available, and we'll give you $1,000 over Kelly Blue Book value for your trade-in. Folks, I guarantee you a hassle-free buying experience. And if you've had credit problems in the past, listen to this. We have an easy pre-approval process. Just go to FletcherCredit.com to get started. You can be pre-approved in minutes. It's really not hard. FletcherCredit.com. Folks, we're also still buying cars every day. If you got an old car or truck you want to turn into cash, bring it to Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood and ask Chris or Andy. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Shop in person or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Thank you.
Do you recycle? Sure you do. Or you'd like to. Recycling is easy because you don't have to separate recyclable material. We'll do that for you. Just throw it in the cart. Loose. No bagging. To do recycling right, you need to know what should go in your cart and what shouldn't. To learn more, go to mydoright.com. At mydoright.com, we'll show you how to do recycling right. Do right and do it the right way.
Your morning drive will never be the same with Morning Mayhem on the radio, live from the Oaklawn Hot Spring Studio, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Josh's parents.
Hey, Josh. In honor of your birthday, your mother and I took a trip to the Poconos. We wrote a lot of things down that were proud of you, but we lost it. So
I think one of my favorites is when they're sipping martinis made from the tears of homeless people. That could be.
Yeah, that was a good one. Pretty awesome.
That's a great line. Roger Scott, live on location in Conway. It's the inaugural Central Arkansas Build My Future event, spotlighting construction career opportunities for students. David Badza has left. He's got to be a part of the Cliff Harris Award. He'll be flying down to Dallas to take care of that, and then we'll be back tomorrow. We'll be back in Little Rock.
How's he flying?
First class. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's flying on a Hatcher Airlines. Oh, my God. And they have sparkling water on that jet. It's going to be beautiful. It's almost, it's the difference. It's the difference between flying commercial and flying on the Hatcher plane is like when Dorothy left Kansas and she made it to Oz. Sure, there was a witch chasing her, but it was all in color and beautiful poppy fields. We are here again for another 30 minutes. We've got some special guests with Alicia Dover. Thank you so much for inviting us to come. Bill Rochelle having us come here to be a part of this event. It's a hands-on, in-depth construction career and industry showcase for high school students is being launched right here today. It's the first one, and I got a feeling you'll do this again just by the folks that have been here today. The hours again today, Bill, are what?
It's going to be 8:30 till 2 o'clock.
8:30 to 2 o'clock. And how many students? How many? Did you say 1,400 Chick-fil-A lunches?
1,400 Chick-fil-A lunches. We picked up the boxes yesterday. I've got a crew that's going at 10:30 this morning to pick up the 1,400 sandwiches. That's something in itself to watch.
Well, that's made an impact with Chick-fil-A today. Going right through. All right, we've got a special guest here with us as well. And he's got a cool story. Michael Leiderman is with us today. Welcome, man.
Yes,
welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Tell us who you're with.
So I am a project manager for Kinko Constructors here in Little Rock.
You're 20, did you say six?
26. Yes,
26 sir. Years old. You got a great story. We're talking about, you know, going to college and some of the things that are happening with student loans and some people, you know, can't afford. Listen, people can't afford to do a lot of things these days. And the college loans, we could get into a whole new show. That's on Sunday Digest with Bill Vickery. We could do that all day long. We're talking about some of the jobs that are here. And Alicia, you were here as well with Bill. And we're talking about, sure, they've got self-checkouts at Walmart and Home Depot and all those things right now, but these jobs still need people. All of these gigs here, you have to, technology has helped, like with that scissor lift that's going to be at Justin Moore's house later today. Some of these things, the technology has helped and the safety has improved, but you still have to have a man or a woman come do some of these jobs. Tell us how you got involved doing this. Tell me your story.
So I grew up in and around the industry. My dad was a residential contractor, so I was always on job sites, 3 years old, going up ladders when I'd run away from them. I never really thought construction was going to be what I wanted to do. He always kind of drove me away because it was a hard life
for
him.
Yeah, absolutely.
Spent a couple summers with him working up in Fayetteville. Got to school at Oklahoma State, was doing a different major. A little too much science, a little too much math there.
You just lost me.
And
Oklahoma State.
And so, you know, I got a job working for a company there. I knew I'm doing this construction thing. Switched majors to construction engineering. The rest was history. You know, while I was working for them too, I started building furniture offhand. So I was working in the field. I was building furniture, just always getting in with my hands.
Well, Justin, you can appreciate something like that because now you will be getting an honorary degree later this year. But you jumped out of school and had
completely
a passion.
Undeserved.
No, well, that's it. You're gonna get it, and you're gonna move that tassel over, my friend, and we're gonna be cheering for you. But you went and you had to go. You had to work. You had to get another job at a young age. You just do what you had to do to move on. So you got a guy like Michael who, you know, decided I can get in. I don't need to take the easy road out. You saw how hard it was. What did your dad say when you said I'm getting back in it, Pop?
You know, he was a big fan of it. He said he knew what I was getting into. But going through the school route, he knew through all the dedication and hard work and money there, that I was not going to have to break my back for, you know, 30 years like he did. And, you know, everybody needs to earn their dues. And that was a big part of the work that I was doing through college and even when I first got to Kinko.
Well, I am not one to poo-poo. It's not what you know, but who you know. That's always good.
Yeah.
It's always good to help you get in the door.
Right.
Yeah. But then you've got to sell yourself, and you can lie, steal, and cheat to get the gig, but you've got to have you've got to be able to perform down the line no matter what it is. Tell me how important this would have been for a guy like you. Would you think, well, again, you didn't think about getting into this field and all this. So
for me, you know, something like this would have been cool to go to at the time with seeing it with dad and as much as he was trying to drive me out, I don't know that it would have driven me to actually go into it. But for high school students, you know, there's a renaissance of construction, if you will, and it's starting to come back. And it's okay to do the manual labor. You don't have to go to school. You don't have to do all of this stuff. And it's not talked about enough in schools. And so events like this, where you really get to put on a showcase, they get to see all of the different things and the technology too.
Well, your dad would have had a booth here. Your dad could. He could have done something like that, and wanted to show. And I'm sure he would teach other students like this or like yourself at that time.
Right.
He would have encouraged them to get involved. Yeah. But he knew how hard it was. But he still loved what he did.
Yeah.
And you can see the labor of love that. I mean, when the guy came over and said, "Hey, you see that PVC bridge over there? I did that."
Yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. Listen, he's proud of what he did, and he could do something like that. I can't read a tape measure. I really can't. I have to go one over. But I mean, now they make it easy. They put all the numbers on that.
Yeah, easy reads.
Absolutely. So when you see something like this, does it make you wish you'd have done something like this?
It does.
Because where you are right now?
It does. I think it would have definitely, I had some good field experience through school, but coming to something like this, really getting to see it all. You know, my dad was a, like I said, residential contractor in a millwork stuff. I would have got to see a bigger picture of the construction, more of a hands-on approach.
Well, when you look out here and see, and I'm sorry, guys, jump in whenever you want. Again, we're all in different locations, but when I see the youngsters that are out here, and there's going to be some here, it's like, it's like going to a bar. You know, I know that person's going to be thrown up later. That one right there, I don't know who she's going home with. And this guy right here, he shouldn't even get his keys. But when I see out here, there's going to be some, it's going to stick, and then it's not. But I see a lot of women involved in the booths. So I know there's a lot of young ladies here. Can you do any of this, Alicia?
You know what? I actually built my dining room table with my dad. Yeah, I did. Good. I did. I helped build the whole thing, helped stain and do the whole table. So yeah, my dad does woodworking, and you know, as a girl dad, he always got us involved in things like that to try and teach us how to do those things. So I'm happy to have a few of those skills. I don't use them a lot.
Does Jeremy? Does your hubby?
He does. Okay. You know, we go to the school of YouTube when something breaks. Yeah.
Samantha, absolutely. My wife wants me to do that as well. I mean, she will say immediately, let's go to YouTube. Let's try to figure this out. And I'll go, we're going to mess it up. I don't have the patience for it and all that.
Yeah. But I'm sure it's inspiring for these women here, you know, to not only just be here and participate, but to see the other women who are running these companies.
Has to. Absolutely.
Yeah. That's the deal. You know, we've got a relationship with the National Association of Women in Construction, and they've got a booth here. And that's what they do, is they promote getting more women involved in the construction industry. And Michael will tell you, we've got some really sharp superintendents, project managers, folks, some ladies out on these job sites that are really, really good.
Well, and I think, who did we have on earlier? I don't know who it was. I don't know if it was you, Bill, or someone else. Of course, growing up, we had the, I can bring home the bacon fried up in a pan and never, you know, that's what
Sheila from Nabholz was on.
That's who it was. It was Sheila. And we were talking about that and all the ladies that get involved. And there was back in the day, that's why when back in TV, back when your grandfather, I'll put it to you that way, Mike, when your grandfather and I were watching TV, the only thing that they had for women, well, you were either a nurse or a secretary. You know, that was it. I mean, the ceiling was it was not. I mean, it was low.
Yeah.
There was not. We didn't see a lot of women running companies and doing all that. And so to see the ladies here, as you just said, that are running these companies and doing that, it's got to be.
Especially, Rod, like you and I. I don't want to speak for you,
sure,
but I think I can. Us being girl dads.
Yeah.
Like, we love seeing this.
Absolutely, absolutely, I do. As a matter of,
and Michael, by the way, buddy, I'm just picking on you.
No, it's all good.
Nothing but all the best, my man.
Hey, we went to the Stillwater Regional, and I was still wearing Razorback Red.
Attaboy,
there you go.
Attaboy, he's still a hog. We still love that. You know,
I'm really envious of your hair.
Hey, I'm
watching on YouTube.
Trying to figure out what to do with the headset.
Listen, you just keep it right there. I'm envious of your hair too. That's why I'm wearing a hat.
You just keep the hair while you got it, my man, because I've lost it on top.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. You know, as far as being a girl dad, I know one of the things that whenever my sons need somebody to help with something, especially writing something or doing something like that, or resumes and this and that, they immediately go to Meredith. Meredith, will you help me do this sort of thing? That's her skill set with what she's got going on. And I couldn't be
more
proud.
I tell you, my wife, Raj, I don't know if Sam's like this, but my wife is much, much, much more handy than I am.
Totally. Totally. There's no doubt. Yeah. She wants to get out there and do stuff.
Not really a joke in our home that if something needs to be done, like, she goes and fixes it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I'm that way too, Justin. Or I'll just use the threat. I'll just go get the drill and say, well, I'm about to fix this. And then it works.
Then it gets done.
Then it gets done because your hubby will be like me and going, oh, it's going to end up costing me a lot more money if I don't do it. I better either jump in, help, see what I can do to do it. Or
hell, I got to change light bulbs in my living room today, and I'm paying somebody to do it.
Well,
with the scissor lift.
I just go, hey, how much is going to cost? I'll play another show. Just
you know what?
Pay somebody to do it.
You know who will do it? We've got a buddy, Robert James Hawk. He will go to Home Depot or wherever. He will rent that scissor lift, and he'll do it himself. That's, I mean, he is that kind of guy.
I'm out. I'd rather just hang out.
He will dig all in. RJ will do all those things. Again, necessity is the mother of invention. And whenever we had to do a lot of those things, like change and do some plumbing and do a little bit of minor things, I'm not talking about doing a French drain or anything like that, but some of those things we need to do that. And they do make it easy now on YouTube and that sort of thing. But this is a great event to have.
Thank you, Roger.
Oh, dude. I mean, and it also, it's good to keep kids off the street. It's giving them something to do. Like we were talking about the people that are in jail. If they can do all those things in jail to make weapons and wicks and this and all that kind of stuff and tattoo, think what they could do here.
Yeah.
It could change their life, and then it'll change some other people's lives because they have the practical experience of and move them on to something, maybe even on their own company. That's what it all is. Well, Michael, it was great meeting you,
yes,
man.
We
appreciate you very much.
Yes,
Bill, thanks for having us come out.
Absolutely. We enjoyed it.
I can't wait for next year. It'll be the second annual event.
And we'll have you back for sure.
We look forward to it. Thank you, Alicia.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right, we'll come back here in just a minute and wrap this moneymaker up live from Conway, the Conway Expo Center, at the Build My Future event happening right now. It's Morning Mayhem.
We never get ahead, but we have another.
Look, Justin.
I watch people evening come right back. I never wanted any part of that. To say I love this place. Good old small town USA.
Hey
Hello there, homeowner. Roger Scott, Philippe Gutters of Arkansas. Are you tired of dealing with clogged gutters, climbing ladders, and worrying about potential damage to your home? Well, listen up to me now. LeafGuard of Arkansas has got you covered. Introducing LeafGuard, the only true one-piece seamless covered gutter system on the market guaranteed to never, ever clog. With LeafGuard, you can kiss goodbye to all the hassle of climbing up and cleaning out all that muck and mud and shingle grit. No more hiring someone else to do it, or worse yet, risking serious damage and issues by doing nothing at all. Spring is finally here, which means it's time for LeafGuard's famous Ugly Gutter event. LeafGuard will swoop in, take down, and haul away all those unsightly gutters at absolutely no charge, and you'll receive an incredible 60% off installation on a whole house LeafGuard gutter system. But wait, there's more. Ask about the 0% financing options and additional discounts for seniors and military personnel. Do not let ugly gutters ruin your home's curb appeal or cause costly damage. Call 501-664-5400 or visit LeafGuardandMore.com to schedule your free estimate today. LeafGuard of Arkansas, protecting your home one seamless gutter at a time.
Are you looking for a dealership to have your back? It's your lucky day. Hubbard Power Sports Can-Am and Sea-Doo of Russellville is your one-stop shop for all things power sports and marine. Our family-owned and operated dealership is celebrating 24 years in business this summer. From our Can-Am and Sea-Doo certified service technicians to our highly knowledgeable sales team, we take pride in how well we take care of our customers. On the road, on the water, or in the trails, we've not only got the ride, but the service for you. Stop by and see us in Russellville or check us out on Facebook today. See our current inventory at hubbardpowersports.com.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at alcoacommunityfcu.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Whoa, Howie, that's a lot of diamonds. What's going on?
We're about to launch the biggest natural loose diamond event we've had in the history of Robert Irwin Jewelers.
Any shape, any size?
Yes, natural loose diamonds for any budget. Plus, get a free men's wedding band with every natural loose diamond purchase. 0% interest for up to 5 years. See a store for complete details.
It's the biggest natural loose diamond and bridal event this weekend at the West Little Rock location in the Pleasant Ridge Town Center.
Robert Irwin Jewelers, home of the meant-to-be guarantee, upgrades are welcome.
I'm still going for it, even with higher stroke risk from atrial fibrillation and a regular heartbeat not caused by a heart valve problem. Over a 3-year study, Eliquis apixaban tablets reduced stroke risk better than warfarin, and over 97% of Eliquis patients did not experience a stroke. A first stroke occurred in 2.9% of warfarin patients versus 2.3% of Eliquis patients.
Don't stop taking prescription Eliquis without asking your doctor. It may increase your stroke risk. Eliquis can cause serious and in rare cases fatal bleeding. Don't take Eliquis if you have an artificial heart valve, abnormal bleeding, or antiphospholipid syndrome. While taking, you may bruise more easily or take longer for bleeding to stop. A spinal injection while on Eliquis increases risk of blood clots, which may cause paralysis, the inability to move. Get medical help right away for unexpected bleeding, unusual bruising, or tingling, numbness, or muscle weakness. Medications such as aspirin products, NSAIDs, SSRIs, SNRIs, and blood thinners may increase bleeding risk. Tell your doctor about all planned medical or dental procedures. Learn more at Eliquis.com or call 1-855-ELIQUIS.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkamp, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with 2 decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it. And at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkamp leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Get the inside scoop from the Hill when Homer's Ace Hardware presents Arkansas second baseman Peyton Stovall on 103.7 The Buzz. Every Tuesday, Peyton joins Roger, David, and Justin on Morning Mayhem. They'll talk college baseball and whatever else comes to mind. It's Peyton Stovall every Tuesday morning with Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz. Made possible by Homer's Ace Hardware. Need help? Ask Homer at any of locations, Searcy, Beebe, or Cabot.
Let's keep the good vibes going. Morning Mayhem is back on the air, live from the Oaklawn Hot Spring Studios, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
All right, we are back. It is the Central Arkansas Build My Future event going on right here. The Zone will be up next. Hey, guys, here's one for us. Now, this is from the guy, Justin, that we just spoke with or that just asked us about the sunglasses and all that. He says, I apologize for challenging you guys. I'm a faithful listener and love the show. So thank you very much, sir, on that one. He also goes on to say, but it did seem like some of the questions made McIntyre uncomfortable. Did it come off that way? Was there a delay that I missed up? Because No. I didn't think that either. But again, if that's what you think, tell Justin.
We asked Will a question that was uncomfortable?
Yeah.
What question would that have been?
I don't know. He just says that they may have that some of them came off in his thoughts, in his opinion.
So he don't want to take my $1,000 bet.
He said to tell you thank you. He doesn't need the dough, and he didn't mean to be confrontational. I just played college baseball, coached 14 years, and haven't seen a pitcher wear sunglasses. God bless you guys. You are all great. Hey, thank you for that. We'll take the blessing. We can have it.
Rog, I love you, but I will say, yeah, that's never happened in the history of baseball. Wearing glasses.
Well, I didn't know. And the reason I had no idea
don't group me into that. I'll challenge you to a I'm not talking about a duel. You. I'm like, I'll challenge you to a duel. Yeah.
Well, 1700 style.
Are you talking about on the sunglasses?
No. No, I'm saying I agree with him that I've never seen any pitcher wear sunglasses.
Well, here's the deal. Neither have I. And that's why I asked, because I don't know what those little flip glasses, you know, they used to see back in the day, you'd see the outfielders that have on glasses, but they'd flip them down, you know, to catch the ball in the sun.
It's like a visor, basically.
Yeah. And that's what I thought. And I'm thinking, well, maybe that's not the way, because here's the thing. They missed the ball yesterday with one pop up in the infield there. They lost it in the sun. Sunglasses or not, you may lose it even without that. But I didn't know, and I'm not going to make any apologies for not knowing.
Yeah, I mean,
no stupid questions.
I don't think it's dumb too. Like, it's not something you really think about until you're actually in the field playing. You know.
Well, and listen. Thank you for listening. We appreciate you being a listener of the show and continue to keep doing that. It was Roger's way. ADHD way of conducting an interview that made him uncomfortable. So that's what it was.
We missed
that.
Okay.
Also, we're in three separate places. Give us a break.
I listened to the whole thing. It sounded fine.
Listen. And he wants to be critical.
I do.
Yeah. He's looking for crap. And that's the voice of Justin Acree. And if he says it was okay, there it is. But again,
hey, Mr. Acree.
Hi, Mr. Moore, how are you?
Hey, Justin Acree. Welcome to Conway, bro. This is like home away from home for you anyway.
Yeah, I love it up here.
All right, talk to me. What's coming up on the Zone? You're here, obviously.
Yeah, happy to be here. And DJ will be along shortly. He's just hustling up from his gig at KRK. So we're going to talk more about building futures today. Great turnout, Raj.
Oh, dude. Yeah, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Over 1,000 expected in here today. So I'm excited.
They've got 1,400 Chick-fil-A lunches ready for people.
I don't need more than 200 of them.
That's it.
Ralph was able to let me in the back door there, so that was good, because the line at the front door was wild as the kids were sort of pouring in here. So it's good. But anyway, we're also going to visit with not only folks here in Conway at the Expo Center, but also Jackson Wells. We had to reschedule him, so we'll talk to him about the Trojans weekend. They just beat UCA yesterday, won 2 out of 3 over the weekend. They've got a home set this weekend. Barrett Salee will join us. And we'll see what else turns up today, but plenty to get to for sure.
All right, very good. Well, thank you again, Alicia. Thank you so much for having us. Bill Rochelle, Ralph, thanks for setting up everything for us today. Great job, Justin Moore and Josh.
Thursday morning at 8 a.m., Tommy Smith visits Morning Mayhem to talk Razorbacks, music, and who knows what else. Tommy Smith is brought to you by Hubbard Power Sports, Can-Am, and Sea-Doo in Russellville. On the road, on the water, and in the trails, they have the ride for you.
After I drop the kids off, I have to run across town for a meeting, hit the gym during lunch, Jake has soccer tonight, and Emily has gymnastics?
Oh, did I turn on the crock pot this morning?
With a never-ending to-do list, it's easy to forget something important, like setting up a life insurance plan with Shelter Insurance. Your local Shelter agent can show you how to create a safety net for your family. Shelter Life Insurance Company, Columbia, Missouri.
For a free insurance review, see Shelter agent Jeff Hodge or Jay Hellman, Little Rock, or Bo Beavis in Cabot.
Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool and Spa 20% off store-wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakusil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool and Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store-wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool and Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.